We've been talking,
been drinking wine and booze. Carl came on last time, said we had to drink wine.
Yeah,
drink wine.
I've got to say, I never thought I'd see you with a cup of red wine in your hand.
It looks weird, doesn't it?
What's that?
You have it at Christmas or when it's like hot red mulled red wine. Is that mulled?
Yeah. I mean, what are you getting in that? What's in the bouquet of that one?
I think that's a Merlot. It's a Merlot, mate.
Right. Well, Merlot to you too. Yeah.
What are you having?
Copperberg.
Cider.
Yeah.
Different drinks for different needs.
I know.
This was supposed to be a fivesome. Not actually sexual.
Who else?
Chip was supposed to be coming.
Oh, right.
Joshua.
Josh, what happened?
Well, so I was with him last night and you texted
me
being
like,
he's
inside a girl's asshole. Oh, wow. He didn't come along because he's too busy sucking the fart out of a girl. And I'm not even joking when I say it. Like, No. I'm actually, hope Chip, even if he just watches the first minute of this,
he will be.
I mean, I genuinely hope it doesn't affect his brand deals, but what's he doing?
So basically, last night, I was like, do you want to come on the podcast? Mm. Me and Carl. And he's like, I'll come on, right? Just not with Carl, because he'll fuck his.
Why? What's wrong with you?
So I feel like, it's only right he didn't say.
Well, he should have turned up because then he could have defended himself, but because he bottled it, it's only fair.
I've got free reign.
Carry on, Carl.
We saw what happened with Dapper last.
So, like, what's that? Like, you know, me and Chip used to be big buds, mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. and guess what's happening? You know, Will's moved down,
mm-hmm. Don't put the blame on me here.
Yeah, and brought this girl into.
Who's the girl? Who's the girl? This is
letter of the alphabet. Letter of the alphabet.
Why?
And next thing I know, Chip, you want to hang out? Oh, you're doing something tonight. Okay.
Oh, what are
you
doing?
Yeah. You know, one
he
of them ones.
Right, last week was probably at my fart. I'd probably saw him for about 72 hours.
How well was he living? Living very well.
You flat shit with said girl.
Well, the problem. That's actually the problem. He's not living very well.
Ah, right.
He sees a light of the tunnel, but he's never going to get to the fucking light.
Why? Does he spend a lot of.
He's just on probation, I'd say, for a
no,
what's he doing?
It's not bad. I'm just saying. Like,
what kind of probation? Like,
if someone told me I had to wait a certain amount of time, right, until I had to listen up,
I'm saying,
you can respect a girl being like, all right. We need to wait 6 months.
He's literally not leaving. I
respect that someone else would say that. I'm not saying therefore you have to do that. I'm respecting that someone else is right to be able to say that. It's amazing that she said
that because I watch these podcasts with a YouTuber.
I don't think that's the point.
She's a legend for that though. She's putting them on ice.
She's got them on string.
No. But the thing is, he's
got them on string.
Yeah, he's literally there like a little puppet, like a dog, and she's got the fucking treat, right? Imagine that. If a girl told me, all right, you have to wait 2 months, I would put a fucking reminder on my phone. I'd go away for 2 months. I'd be like, right, it's been 2 months.
I'll see you 2 months, pet.
Yeah.
I'm not sure that's what she means. Let's just put it that way. If he went away for 6 months and then came back and went, I've done my six. Not what she means.
Well, do you know what? That's what you fucking said. So
if we're saying 2 months,
so where's my sex?
So if we're saying 2 months is, for example, what she said he has to wait. For example.
Sure.
How far into that is he? How far?
What, not very far.
Oh, weeks. Weeks.
Do you know the worst bit about this is I watch these podcasts with her.
Wow. Shout out to her. Thanks for watching. We haven't got many female viewers. I want to hold on to them. So I'll defend your right to keep them waiting as long as you fucking well want.
When you say you watch them with her, Will, are you sort of lying in bed? Or
Brian, do you know what? It's funny you bring that up because Will is actually a bit of a cuck in that relationship.
Oh, don't even try this at all.
No, when you say cuck,
I'm trying. Go on then. What was it?
Social justice warrior. What's that?
What was it? Go on.
No. So you often actually in a way Will is put in an unfortunate position because of his living situation
already,
because of his living
he's
but
the third
at
wheel.
The same time
third wheel.
But he agrees with that
I'm not gonna cook's a bit far like if I'm dropping this tin on
maybe not a cut. Let's go with third wheel.
Record them while Chip does her doggy style.
Wait,
oh, I don't know. I reckon.
What?
I'm just asking.
Wait,
go on. It's a question.
Well, Lisa will probably be up by then anyway.
But there you go. So that's why Chip's not on.
Oh, right. That explains that. What doesn't explain, though, is that was that picture that went on Twitter?
Which one?
Fart sucking.
Someone posted it of, was that of Chip in the mirror? In little fucking skinny Y fronts or something?
No, that wasn't Chip. We just Googled.
That was actually the girlies after?
Right, because someone said that was Chip, and I was like,
oh, no, someone said that was me.
Something else you posted on
the site. I knew it wasn't you. Geordies are hung way better than that.
You put.
Something from personal experience, anyway. I can only...
What, from being with other Geordies?
Yeah, you've been with
Geordie girls. Well, big clits. I've got some big clits, Geordie girls, I tell you.
Jesus,
just the way I like them.
This is going down a similar poet and voodoo sort of route now.
No, it really has gone out of hand, hasn't it? Early doors.
One thing you posted on Twitter earlier, Will, was a pizza delivery machine.
Oh, that was a madness. So we were driving along.
All right, poet.
What? Well, I'm obviously from like North London. So we were driving along, and there was this little white like box thing just going along the road, minding its own business, and like stopping. And everyone's like walking past and looking at it. And I like put it on Snapchat, and I was like, "Yeah, Domino's are using it to deliver pizza."
Brilliant.
Like, think, if they unrolled that right in the Northeast, no one's getting their pizza.
Yeah. Like, no, they'd be literally hundreds of
wheels
these
aren't
white
even
things.
Getting there.
No, you say it might not get delivered in Newcastle, but like what, London going to be much better? Is it going to get delivered up in Hackney? Probably
like,
not.
The select areas that it's just you're not getting.
Sure.
Yeah. Literally, someone will have like a chisel and just be whacking.
Oh,
into
fully.
The,
like
whilst walking,
take
the wheels off it. Like the whole thing. Do a trick on the car.
The whole thing. I mean, people would
to
just.
To be fair, you'd rather have the little robot dog thing instead of the pizza anyway, wouldn't you? Like that's a decent ornament.
Do you think imagine that it just like turns up? You're like, right, there's my pizza. Yeah. And you take the whole thing inside. Like, I've just got myself a new pet.
Well, speaking of weird robotic shit. You've just been to Japan, mate.
Yeah,
that's the king.
He's talking
of that
about Japan,
place.
It's not a slight on you.
Who did you go with?
I went with my ex girlfriend. Actually,
did you really?
Yeah, I actually did.
Was she your ex before?
No. It was we booked when before we'd split up. But
fucking hell.
But it's actually fun because we get on really well still. So it's fine.
I mean, it's been pretty real so far. So was it? A romantic,
how's it like being in a committed relationship?
I mean, we didn't sleep in the same bed and just read each other's stories, good night. But I mean, it was just one of those things. We both knew what was like going on, and it was fine. I actually had a good time in Tokyo.
Mutual.
Would you like a rebel?
Mutual. No, thank you.
Okay,
I'm good. But yeah, no, Tokyo, one of the most interesting places that I've been to.
Why?
Really, it's just so different to anywhere. There's nowhere else in the. I've done quite a bit of traveling, and there's nowhere else in the world that has made me go like just learn so many new things about the way they do. Everyone's so respectful there, and it's just it's amazing. And the food, if you're into like trying new things, if you're not into trying new things and you just have fish and chips every night, probably not the place for you. But worth going to. And also, you can pay people to while you're taking a shit to suck you off. In a certain district, which would be pretty cool.
That's a thing.
Not from experience. Yeah.
While taking a shit?
Gone through my mind whilst I was taking a shit. Like, I would never think this is an optimum time. Like,
it's called a Boston steamer.
Are you serious?
You're quite cultured.
No,
How did you come across this information? Like,
well, I had a £20 discount and I thought,
no,
I'm
if you downloaded the app now,
use TRUE10 as the discount code.
Please don't.
That is really weird, though.
Yeah, well, it was weird, but...
When I'm having a shit, I never feel, like...
You need to be
sexual.
Off.
Can like,
I answer
you know
that?
What I mean?
Can I answer that?
It's more of a, just a practical thing, really. Get it done, you know? But one thing I do find is...
Do you have a
that is my
you?
That is when I'm more likely to read comments on YouTube or Twitter or whatever. So, like, usually if I'm replying to people... I mean, that's probably what's going down.
Can you say next time you take a shit, can we come up with a code word that you tweet that then people know that you're reading the comments?
Maybe toilet entertainment? Because
it's not very code.
Yeah, that's the same as being like, should we come up with a safe word? Yeah, what is it? Cook. Safe word. Mm.
Cook.
No, but if you just tweet the word cuck, that's the same as playing your shitty YouTube channel game where you have to tweet that shit out if you get it wrong.
Oh, he just turned this to me on a
YouTube
video.
YouTube mastermind.
I thought we were mates.
Ah, YouTube mastermind. Right, now that's brilliant.
I was on that show. That's a credible. We've all done.
No, that was offensive, Laurence.
Have you done
we
that?
We were mates.
Still waiting for the invite. It's just in the post. It's just
it's if you'd stay in the country for a little bit. Exactly.
Yeah.
I did offer. You know
what? Japanese porn, that's different. They definitely
what,
do.
Hentai, the anime, the tentacles in the vagina.
Do they play that as well? The hentai one? Because you know how they blur all the goings on.
They blur the dicks, don't they?
They blur the dicks, but the tentacles do whatever you want. Maybe that's why they had to come up with
that.
Yeah,
but did they blur the hentai as well?
Yeah, exactly. They probably had to come up with things that look
like
tentacles.
I like the bus porn that they do, where sort of a girl's riding the bus on the way to work, and then next thing I know, a man just and he just accidentally crotches up against her, and then next thing you know, hand up the skirt, Nick has her down, just getting fucked in front of everyone.
Right. Mm. Yeah. Sure.
Every man's fantasy.
Yeah. No, I've just, I quite enjoyed that a little bit. Yeah. Just a little bit.
You quite enjoyed that a little bit?
Maybe more than a little bit.
So sure. Wait, have you ever watched hentai or any of that
stuff? I haven't. No, I've seen...
actually never watched it, but I tell you who is a big advocate of it.
Who's that?
He's been on the podcast.
I think. Whoa, I know who.
No,
you're going to say.
Wait,
it's not. Who, go on.
Just has to be JJ, doesn't it?
It just fucking is.
And it was.
No, but do you know what? Yeah, do you know what?
I was hoping it was Theo. I was really hoping it was Theo.
Stephen tries, like, fully getting stuck in. Yeah, yeah.
Nah, I just knew it was JJ straight away because he's just fucking mad.
Yeah, well, actually, he wouldn't give a fuck. He doesn't give a fuck.
Deji is supposed to be coming on the podcast.
Right, right, right.
Is there anything you think we should ask Deji when he comes on?
So do you know what? Yeah, Deji actually is a bit of a player.
Yep. Oh, no, he was like, I can't do this Friday. I'm not sure about next Friday. Maybe the Friday after, because I'm booked to see girls on those days.
Yeah, wow. Yeah.
Yeah, no, fair play to him.
But what's interesting is I've spoken to some of these girls that have melt with JJ. And Deji, but you actually need to speak to Deji and just ask him about, like, sort of his stories.
All right.
Because he has some good stories.
I bet he does. Yeah. Driving around in that car at his age. I mean,
what
car is fucking Lambo, isn't it?
Hurricane, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a good... And a Range Rover, I think.
Done by Yanomize.
The
guy who parks across two parking spaces.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, he says Jesus. As he chews into his Rebels.
I mean, you're not supposed to fucking eat during a fucking podcast. Yeah, I know
they sound great.
Yeah, you know how you say it? You said, you know, recently you said, like, in the problem with London is there's too many Pret and not enough Greggs, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So I was in a Pret this morning. I just wanted a cheese naan toasty, right? All they had was like fucking falafel salads.
Mate,
and, like,
it's a joke.
You know, I actually quite like Pret, actually.
Yeah,
they do quite a decent, like, tuna melt. Yeah.
But if you could get some normal stuff like that, that's fine. But, like, a lot of the stuff, it's exactly what a Geordie coming to London would think London is like. When I went in there, I'm looking around like, avocados, where's the fucking sausage rolls? Like,
yeah.
Do you know, like, that's kind of...
They don't have enough of those, and like classic, like, fish and chip shop, like those sort of thing. They don't have enough of
those. There's if regular English places, there's not many of them in London. Right. And that's not me being racist. It's just true.
No, it isn't racist to say that.
Would you consider yourself Northern? Because you've lived... Scotland,
obviously not Northern. Well, do you consider Scotland
Northern? Yeah, quite.
Well, not even actually, because I've probably spent. Well, I don't know. I'd consider myself from the United Kingdom.
Right.
He's global.
Everything.
Yeah.
Everything.
United Kingdom.
What exists?
That's just me. But we went over this the whole of the last podcast.
I mean, yeah. That's
everyone.
I'm trying to think of other things I've seen about Japan.
Well, there's that. Okay, so another
thing. PlayStation.
No, here's another one. They're called maid cafes.
Right.
Okay, and so you go in. I mean, you would be a big fan of these, I reckon. Like,
it sounds awesome.
Little Asian girls dressed up in like maid outfits, like very provocative maid outfits. They serve you like in the very like squeaky anime voice.
Oh, yeah, I like that.
Literally. Yeah. And do you know what's funny is that your stereotype is that, you know, they have this squeaky voice. And I thought, oh, well, surely it's not like that. It's just like, it's what
they're putting it on.
Mate, honestly, they're all.
I like that voice.
That's what I'm saying is I think you would really.
Because when
like
when they're getting fucked on the porn and that, it's almost like it's like a squeaky cry sound that they put out, isn't it? Like
one more time. Well,
like,
so you like the sound of them being in pain?
Well, almost. Not pain. I don't want to cause women pain.
Yeah,
but I'm just
sometimes you do.
I'm just that big. It's uncomfortable. That's what I like.
But what kind of noise?
Huh?
Could you give us a noise again?
It's that sort of one, isn't it?
Like a fox in the night.
Because I remember when I went, when I went to Amsterdam, I found this Thai massage place.
Great.
And when I went, the
like
front
everyone
door,
goes to Amsterdam.
It
for.
Was like a big house inside, and the girl.
That's what doors tend to lead to.
And two people or whatever, because maybe pal were there and that. And she went, "I take care of you," and I just thought, if only every woman spoke to me like that, I would be really happy with life.
Really?
No,
every woman, it was
just...
Go into Greg's, I take care of you.
Honestly, if every woman said that to me, I would just feel better about life.
Tesco checkout, I take care of you.
It sounds nice.
Get on the bus.
And if they look like her, it would help as well, like, to be honest, because...
sure.
Well,
you know. Yeah, there's not enough attractive missing, women for you, are there? Yeah. What happened after that? You just sort of...
So I went upstairs, sort of rubbed us down and all that.
Sure.
Flipped us over.
Wow.
Rubbed you down even more.
One of them, innit?
Finger up the arse.
No, that wasn't offered. Wait,
have you actually ever had that before?
I've had a woman sort of around the area, but never actually...
Never been penetrated.
No. It's been tickled.
Look at his face. Look at the way he scratches his face.
Well, we all know... No, yes, you have.
I swear down on whoever's life you want, I haven't had.
All right, anyway. I don't think there's any... shame in it, really, because the tickling didn't feel too bad.
I've got mates who really enjoy it.
So do
I. Anything near there, I'm like, whoa.
Yeah, I'm not getting a little bit.
There's a reason why.
Your penis is quite close to your ass. That's the issue.
There's a reason why pokey bum wank is a thing, though, because a lot of men do enjoy it, though.
Wasn't that a Japanese series as well?
But the
Pokemon,
she never tickled or anything like that. It was pretty straightforward, standard on the dick. But her poor little forearms. I mean, honestly, you know when you'd have a drink the night before, but you've had a skinful. So she is whacking away as hard as she can. And by the end, I mean, she really had to almost strangle the life out of it. I was thinking to myself, I'm really enjoying this, but there's no way I'm going to come. Like, because I'd had that much booze the night before, and I was still fucking steaming.
Talking about the Thai massage?
Yeah.
So she's like, oh, you can touch us if you want. She went, you can touch us if you want. So I started touching her and she went, not that hard. Like, because I was really...
You were strangling her.
Forceful.
under the ground.
I just touched her ass, to be honest. I didn't realise it was that hard, but...
You almost killed her.
Eventually I was like, it's all right. I'll leave it there. So I finished the job off later on my own. There was a moment on that cruise, because I went on it was a cruise ship that goes from Newcastle straight to Amsterdam.
How exotic.
Ideal. Could make for a good vlog one day.
Okay, Will. Understood.
Two of you get for a little pokey bump.
And I woke up at about 3 o'clock in the morning or whatever. My mate had he had really bad cotton mouth from all the fucking weed he'd been smoking and that. And he's looking in the mirror and he's stark bollock naked and that. And he's just staring at the mirror, like gazing. God knows how long he'd been there.
Just two straight guys naked
back
in
and
a room.
Forward. I mean, I've seen plenty of naked blokes before, for fuck's sake. Anyway, he goes, it gives you a tremendous cotton mouth, and he's just swaying there on his own. And I'm just looking at him like, fucking hell, what a weird little man.
Yeah.
And that was the Amsterdam.
We never spoke about it again, innit?
No, I mean, I just rolled over and went back to sleep. Separate beds. Yeah, so
sure.
Yep.
Nice one.
That was that. High in Thai porn.
You travel a lot, Will.
I did before uni and then haven't really done much since.
What I've noticed about Will is since coming to London,
brilliant.
Grown up quite a bit.
Oh right, okay.
Seem to be a bit you just seem to be a bit more
mature.
Confident in that, aye. Because you're in the big bad world on your own. Well, big Shaz isn't here to look after you anymore, mate. Gotta wipe your own arse.
Jesus.
Pokey bum wank.
Odds on that being the title of this video.
Age restricted.
To be fair, I'll probably have to put WillNE and Calfreezy in the title for the views, but I would like to call it Pokey Bum Wank, if that makes any
spirit.
In everyone's mind.
Or Pokey Bum Wank with WillNE and Calfreezy.
And that's the wrong website, the jackpot.
I've got a pretty good Photoshop guy as well, so we could get all sorts of work.
Soon you'll be in on that.
Human centipede. Yeah. Where have you travelled?
So I went round Europe just before I went to uni. Damn.
You need to crack on. I'm almost through my first bottle.
Mate, I've been doing two bottles at once, so you cannot hold that against
us. Summer
red. I'm not really into that, though. Malos.
Wait, so how long into this podcast are we? Like 20, 25?
what are we, cameraman?
Twenty.
We're going to be doing about six bottles of wine by the end of this.
Well, someone's a big lad.
What can I say? Well, it says you on a Corona.
To be fair, I've got one left, so I'm going to be nursing it after this.
Yeah.
Wow. Smashing two Coronas.
What was it like traveling Europe before uni?
I just kind of went around for a month. I don't know if I really like traveling. I feel like I can do it for a bit, but I just kind of want to be home. Are you?
No.
You don't like traveling.
This
you just
is
don't
the
like
travel
move.
End.
Okay, but you don't
I
like
don't,
moving.
I don't mind different places. It's the fucking on getting from place to place.
I love the
actual travel bit. Yeah. Being on an airplane, or I think it's just because I'm a big bloke, or being on a train or whatever. When I get there, I'm perfectly happy, as long as I can go at my own pace.
You don't look it.
No, that was because that wasn't a proper holiday. It was like we were running all over the place. Do you know what I mean? If I was on doing my own thing, like, do I want to go over there? Yeah, I'll go over there then.
Is that your thought process? Mm.
Come That's on, my buddy. Brain talking to me.
Yeah. Do I want to go over there?
Yeah.
But yeah, Do you think it's different when you come from Newcastle? That is,
no,
it's more different to
what to.
Like, I think if you went from, I don't know, London to Milan, Milan to Barcelona, it's sort of...
I think, actually, yes, in a way. You wouldn't know, because if you lived in London, like, it's massive, so you're used to being, like, travelling a decent way or being, like, so busy. But sometimes if you travel from Newcastle to a big city,
right,
it's a bigger culture change than if you are from London.
So getting anywhere in London, you get in any car and you go, can I go here in London? They go, half an hour. Because it could be 50 minutes, could be 45 minutes, I just say half an hour. But the point is, in Newcastle, like most places, is like 10 minutes or whatever. Like,
so you're saying convenience? What does that
have? It's just... the ordeal of getting anywhere in Newcastle is not there, whereas in London, everything's a fuck on, and that becomes normality to you. So if you go from London to Barcelona, Barcelona to Paris or whatever, right, it's just normality being in that
you're
big...
You're socially conditioned.
Yeah, I'm just not... It was a bit of a shock to me coming down to London and having to be here so much, to be
honest.
I've
got to admit, when you did first come down to London, it was quite tricky to get you to go anywhere. I mean, like, we would literally... I'd be like, oh, it's just a 5-minute walk down there.
Yeah, and that's, I have not seen them walk very far.
Well, no. I mean, and then we'd be sort of walking to this place and we'd be 2 minutes in and he'd be like, oh,
don't you have that
Uber thing here? And you'd be like, well, yeah, we
Uber
do.
Thing. But, I didn't know what Uber was.
And then we'd get in the back of an Uber and he'd go... oh, fucking hell. Electric cars.
Whee! Total bollocks for fair play.
And we'd end up at a burger joint or another burger joint. And then we'd leave it. And I go, well, I'm going to go back that way now. And he's going to go back to my hotel. And then he go, cool, see ya. You want to order me an Uber before you go?
I still haven't got Uber now. I've been here fucking months.
Yeah. You force a producer to get you Ubers.
Yeah.
It's quite sweet, really.
I mean, I've got to give her something to do. She's earning a fuck ton for what she's doing.
Yeah, if you live in Newcastle, she probably is. Yeah.
I mean, yeah.
Did you film a lot in Japan?
No, I didn't film anything.
Mm. Is that liberating?
Shame.
Yeah, I like it. I never actually put like my girlfriend or anything like that on social media. I'm not
Josh.
Speaking of that.
Josh, what's up with Josh?
Chip.
Does he post a lot of...
It's that slyly unintentional. Oh, is that her giggling in the background? You know where I'm coming from.
So every clip you hear him go, hey guys, brilliant.
Yeah, so pretty much that. But no, eventually, I don't know. Wait, do you guys post it on social media?
Yeah.
Social media?
I wouldn't. I don't think I've seen. I wouldn't, regardless, mate, because I'd rather keep my options open. You know,
that's interesting. I'm the opposite of that. So I sort of like, I feel like I found the girl. So I'm like, I'll just post photos of her. I think she's beautiful. Why not?
Oh, there is the alternative rule of thumb, which is if you feel like you found the perfect girl, maybe best for her sake to keep her out of the limelight as well.
Just keep her away from people.
No, good point, actually. Yeah.
Just an alternative.
It's a mad one though. As soon as you involve a relationship in social media, like it puts so much more pressure on. I've never had it whilst I was on YouTube or anything. But like, if you bring it into it, like the audience becomes part of it. Like they have to split up, they have to put like statements.
Imagine right now, and obviously I hope this doesn't happen because I bloody love them. Spen and Alex, to me, they've got a channel together. Like, she has been a massive part of him getting where he was. And like that relationship is so, it's publicised. You don't really know what the inner goings on are, but
they're
you've
like
seen
Richard
them.
And Judy, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. They're the Richard and Judy or whatever of YouTube. Like that couple. Like if they split up now,
yeah,
it'd be a fucking. I'd actually be gutted.
Like, you know what I'd do? Zoella Alfie.
Yeah.
That would be a.
Oh god,
that would be a fucking destruction.
The magazines would have a field.
They would Mandelson each other. There'd be a PR war going on of who was to blame.
Mandelson was a political figure at some point in the 90s. Just so you guys know.
Yeah. Don't know an audience there.
No, I'm just saying it's probably a really out reference there.
Yeah, sorry.
That'll help.
That would be mad though. I mean, yeah. YouTube relationships, big. Have you ever known someone who regrets? I think JJ said he wishes he didn't put Shauna in the original girlfriend
Q&A. I think it was more for Shauna's sake.
Oh yeah, that's what I mean.
Yeah. Well, that's the thing you often find, especially for the girl. It always ends up being slightly worse for the person that's like less famous.
But they can't build Instagram careers.
So it's Alfie.
It depends.
It's how you play it, really, isn't it? Yeah.
I don't know. It's just stupid. But yeah, no, I think you'd find if any girl went on there, I think it'd just be.
I noticed JJ deleted that video actually. I was looking through his videos the other day.
He's deleted loads. It's not just.
Yeah, I don't know, mate. Fuck tons.
He had a bit of a problem after he came on our podcast.
Yeah, he's not really a problem. He's just gone off the radar, isn't he, publicly?
It's actually really
apparently
good.
He's booked a holiday.
Yeah.
Are you going on holiday?
I imagine it's really
refreshing.
Did you get an offer?
Well, off our mate Chip, but...
It's always nice to get an offer for something. I never got an offer for the birthday party that he had.
Oh, don't even try
You know,
that.
It's funny as well. He messaged me and was like, should I invite Brian? I was like, definitely go for it. And then next thing you know, he was like, actually, I've decided against it. I said, well, that's on you.
I got a tweet from someone saying, did you enjoy Will's party? And I just quoted it saying, what party?
It was very naughty of you to stir it like that, but fair enough.
Stephen Tries went though, so it's nice though. Yeah.
Isn't it nice to see your friends having fun with your other friends? Mm.
I remember when Will didn't know any of the YouTube lads and I brought him to the Wembley Cup party.
Oh yeah, have you been saving this for a while? This was like 4 weeks ago.
Off me own back. And
he just kept telling me how he'd outgrown True Geordie.
From day one.
That's literally all he was going on about the whole birthday. A couple bevs down him, that's what he was
doing. From day one, I felt like his big brother. You know, I feel like I've got to look after this lad and give him any help he needs. But
I hope it was a good birthday.
What birthday was it?
Well, I actually tell you, it was a great birthday.
Was it the big 21?
Yeah, it was. I just didn't think
he wanted
to be around.
He had his last big birthday without me, though.
Yeah, are we done yet?
What's the symbol for 21? Is it a snake?
I think it is.
Yeah.
It's a 2 and then a 1,
yeah.
From what I remember.
To whoever your minder is. Mm-hmm.
So how did that go anyway? I've seen Stephen Tries got covered in...
Videos of Callan buttoning...
I want to know all about it.
Wait, can I ask you just about the podcast? You actually bring up a good point. So you know when I see the podcast and you guys sometimes reference certain pictures or images, can you guys maybe just spend a bit more money and get the editor to actually throw that up there?
I mean,
we got the guy here, you know.
He's saying that
the camera guy just literally made a reference, like, show me the money, bitch.
What's that, an extra 50?
No, but you actually 100. Should. Like, I watch these podcasts and you'll reference certain things, and then I have to pause, new tab. What the fuck are they on about?
Ooh, is Serbian film.
Lads, step your game up. I mean, you've heard the lad. So
sorry. Jay, I didn't mean to.
Jay's just raised his eyebrow, like
Pusha T's fine off. With it, but what is? What
he looked like
saying?
Clint Eastwood there. Like, are you talking to me, punk?
Okay, no, I agree though. But then tabbed browsing is the future.
What happened? Who got the worst of it? Was it Stephen Tries?
Stephen
fell asleep.
Stephen just got, because it's like you see Stephen, you're like, yeah, fuck, we'll get Stephen a drink. Like, you'll just like keep feeding Stephen, and then the kids.
How is he when he's drunk?
Well, when he came to Preeze, he was like, look, I'm not going to drink until 20 half an hour.
2012.
Shut up, man, right? Like 20 minutes, 30 minutes before we go out. He was like, because I'll just get too fucked. And I was like, well, like, for real. And then he was like, yeah. And then he just went off
because I turned up literally 20 minutes before we were about to go out. I was really late to Preeze. I turned up, Stephen was already fucking trolling. and I was literally like, and he was like, oh, it's so great to meet you, like, all this story. I was like, oh, Stephen, you good? And then at that point, I thought he was just quite enthusiastic. Yeah. And then at that point,
no,
I realized,
never like that.
Actually, he's fucking hammered.
And it
only got worse through the night. Well, not worse. Like, he was obviously a lovely guy throughout the whole night, but he just got more and more insane. And then we ended up back at Will's place, and he was literally just sitting on the couch. Everyone would be like, oh, he's asleep. He's like, how asleep is he? Next thing you know, shirts off, everything, nipples, everything.
It can't be like, right, Will, I want to cock all the way down to his belly button, and he doesn't even flinch when he put him on it. Like, he's
gone. We get those pictures sent to the editor?
Yeah. I was literally like, I have all it. But to be fair, there was plenty of incriminating stuff on that thing.
Snapchat.
On that birthday party. Yeah.
What's going on with you, though? Did you pull any birds around? It's your birthday. Surely you did.
There was. You dare say one name.
She's known then? Is she?
No.
Is she known?
No. No.
She's not a YouTube girl or
anything. Well, yeah, but not.
Well, okay.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is...
So the football on the weekend, like, what's the predictions? Or do you want to stay on this topic?
No. Really, well, all I was going to say is, I was there.
I could just tell you her name. Do you want to know her name?
Oh, I want to know her name.
No, I'm not going to tell you her name. Will will tell you her name. Will will tell you her name. I've fucked Chip over the last...
What?
You know, Will's
I'm fine.
Don't need a name though, do you?
We do. It's the True Geordie podcast, mate. We lay shit bare. That's what we do.
No, but the thing is, if he was to say a name, you wouldn't know her.
All right,
you wouldn't know her.
Can I see a picture anyway? That'd be good.
Well,
if that's all right, yeah.
I mean, what sort of picture?
Oh no, just a regular picture. Just a regular one.
Yeah, speak for yourself.
Until you stipulated you didn't want to see a nude, he was going to show you a picture.
But I didn't say a nude.
Fuck's sake, I fucked myself out of a
normal picture. of a YouTuber.
Oh. It's just an Instagram profile. So, yeah. Like, it's not that.
Damn it. Oh, I could have seen a load of
I've been thinking about getting this is right. Four lads around the table, yeah. I've been thinking about getting a girl on the podcast.
Brilliant.
But it's like who do you get though? Do you know what I mean?
Really.
Who do you get?
Asa Akira.
Is she a YouTuber though?
Who cares?
Yeah, I mean,
what, are you a YouTuber only podcast? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Definitely not, but if they're in London, that's because she's a she's an Asian. I think she's
you put Suella in your titles enough. Why don't you get her on someone?
Just the once, mate. Fuck me. Just because I'm doing what you're an expert at.
You
don't want to put you out of business.
No, I mean, I'm just laughing at you guys going out.
Wouldn't want to put him out of business. No,
I saw your thumbnail and thought, he's literally sat down with her. Like, you did that so well.
Loads of people.
No, it's decent. Like, it's only the thumbnail. No,
if you watch, look at that thumbnail and you're just glazing over, you would have thought that was pretty realistic.
Thumbnails.
I literally just put my green screen video and paused it and then put that picture of her in the background, and that was there was no Photoshop.
Can we also talk about you filming with an iPad until this point? Like, the fact you've only
you filmed with an iPad
until like 2 or 3 weeks ago. You used to film with a phone and an iPad, didn't you? In a green screen.
Yeah, I've never had a proper camera until I hit. I didn't know, about 385.
That's mad. Like, that's actually, I mean,
that's impressive. I mean, that's impressive, if anything.
Even better are the DSLR stories he told me when he first got a DSLR.
Because I was texting him. So I basically just bought a Canon. And obviously, him being the fucking king of cameras and that. Yeah. So I'm texting him all my questions, and I'm like, because literally,
how does it turn on?
Literally,
Google's right there. You dumb prick.
Brian, take a lens cup.
No, yeah.
Well, this is the funny thing, right? It's very dark in this room. Well, Brian, no.
Oh, that was the best one. So obviously, I'm used to the iPad, which or the iPhone, which is all works the same. You literally sit it on an ironing board, or whatever you may choose.
What was it?
You rest it up against something. You press record, and then you plug it in to your computer after you've recorded, and there's your video. It's done.
Wow.
Whereas
technology.
On this, what I didn't realise was there's a zoom function and it was already zoomed in. So I'd sat the camera all the way across the room.
Oh my God.
Press record. And then people were commenting.
He's got a massive nose.
I can't really hear you.
No, it wasn't zoomed right in. It was. I'd had to push it so far away.
Oh. He'd zoomed in and gone, oh, that's a very tight frame. Instead of thinking, I'll try the zoom function, he went,
he's moved it really
I'll move
far.
The camera further back.
Yeah, yeah.
Open the French doors.
So anyway, there was a proper echo on the video because I'm sat halfway across the fucking room. And then after I'd finished the video, I picked the camera up and
accident,
I toggled the lens and I went... an hour later or whatever
so
it was.
Fully, you'll have bought that iPad being like, oh, it's big, it's got a good camera on. Like, did you buy the iPad specifically as for the camera on it?
No, I literally bought the iPad for YouTube.
Yeah, yeah, I bet you'd be like, oh, it's a big one, I'll have a good camera on it. Sit it down. Yeah.
Did they tell you in the shop, like, it's got iMovie?
My knowledge
like that,
of technology is pathetic.
Oh, but you ate on Premiere Pro, though. I saw you take digs at that.
Did you watch
that podcast with Harry on? I'm getting the hang of it, Premiere Pro.
When you tweeted that screenshot out, genuinely,
were you a little bit
felt sick.
Oh, did you actually?
Yeah.
What was it?
He zoomed out of the video on the little palette.
Yeah. That was just, I think.
Window
was...
orientation was
no,
all
it's
over
more
the
like
place.
Vegas if I do it like that. And I get angry when I try and learn stuff, like really annoyed. Like, it's just something I don't enjoy.
Really, it's two ends of the table, isn't it?
I can tell by your videos, though, that you're a perfectionist.
With comic
cutting and panning.
I just can tell that everything is like.
And focus being on the sun in the background.
I can tell by the way he cuts, though, it's so pinpoint. Like, he doesn't just go, cut there, cut there.
Well, to be fair, if he's sloppy, he probably wouldn't be where he is.
Yeah. Yeah.
At this end of the table.
I do love,
maybe
though, you,
there,
you
the
can.
Important side.
The best part of tuning into your videos is you always choose the end of the day to sort of film your videos.
This was so funny.
I went around and I went to film the video with Will that I just uploaded, right?
And over underrated. I like it.
Did you like it?
Mate, I rated it.
I thought it was very funny.
Underrated series, maybe, yeah? All right, anyways, I go there and I'm talking to him and he's like, oh, only got about an hour in between. So, why is that? Well, you know, the sun sets at about this time.
I always film in front of a window. I'm just like, oh, that looks decent. So I've got a film between like, well, before the clocks change, that's fucked me right up.
Yeah.
But like between like 10 past 4 and 10 past 5, like that's my window.
Yeah. Do you have a phone? Do you have a mobile phone?
What? Yeah.
Yeah. Do you ever just use the sunset app?
What?
Yeah, it'll tell you when it's going to sunset.
That's a shout. That actually is a good shout.
Wow.
Decent.
He's just sitting there,
he's
like
going,
right.
Natural light.
Yeah.
If you sun will be in there. Hold on, Legolas, the sun's like, coming down.
I literally could not be fucked with any of that, man. I've only just got a camera.
No, I know.
You know
well,
I
you're
mean?
Too busy trying to work out how to get it closer to you. That's
worried
your main
with
issue.
The fucking sunset.
Yeah.
To be fair, I like the fact that you've got like good background. You've always had that, but I cannot be fucked with green screen anymore. But I also can't be fucked.
Oh, well, easier.
I swear you still use the green screen.
I do, mate. I'm sick to death of it.
He uses the green screen.
I keyed out. I was keying out on a fucking iPhone.
I still live in Newcastle.
It's amazing. I should be work at NASA for keying out on an iPhone, mate.
Yeah, they need loads of people that can key out at NASA.
Yeah.
Here's a that joke about
right
the moon.
Yeah, that joke ran on my head.
Do you think we actually landed on the moon?
Taking drugs.
I do.
You really do think, you think America landed on the moon?
You're saying as if you don't think that was the case.
I'm just trying to trigger.
Let's try to trigger
are you
on
one
this.
Of those, do you, like, no, when you see I, a conspiracy,
wait,
do you get behind it? Or
he's the opposite of a conspiracy
theory. Oh, do you think
I'm not
that
the opposite,
as well?
I'm just cynical of everyone's theories. Just not.
No, no,
just,
I'm with you. I'm
just
with
not
you.
Leftists.
Right, I don't want to go into it because I know that we'll just go like, we'll just be here for the next like 4 or 5 hours.
Okay.
But can we just go around the table and ask?
And just say whether we believe.
No, about 9/11 being an inside job.
Oh.
We can't, that is the rule. We cannot talk about
it. His pupils dilate. He was like, finally, the podcast comes to the point I want.
No.
People are asking me the questions I care about.
Okay, go on then. We'll go around.
All right, we'll start. Laurence, inside.
Just straight up.
No. Inside.
Wait, I think the best way to do it is to do. Do you believe the official story or not?
No, but right. I don't think it's a fully inside job.
Okay.
No, I don't believe the normal story either.
What, you don't believe the normal story? Okay.
This isn't a controversial question anymore.
Jet fuel, steel beams.
No.
Do you believe?
No. I think we should go with. Do you think it was an inside job?
No.
Inside job?
No.
Oh, fuck me. It's just not a no, yes or no question, though,
is it? Is it an inside job? Because I'm not going to go into it. Just like, would you lean to more towards the inside job route, or would you lean more towards the fact that it was all the way they said it happened?
It's just such a fuck. To be honest.
No, I just want a yes or no.
No,
please.
I
don't want to go into it.
Right, without getting all serious, so many thousands of people died in that. And for me to just there's so much information I've taken in about this, and I'm still not fully one way or the other. I'm just very like, the official story is bullshit. The idea that people with box cutters who had very little flight ability could take over Boeing 747s and control them into a fucking building with little to no experience of that and hit all their targets.
This
well, 75%
exactly
of the targets.
I didn't want when I said
I struggle to believe it, but I equally struggle to. Yeah, I struggle to believe the official story, but I also struggle to believe that.
The government did it.
Yeah, because you just don't want to, do you? Do you know what I mean?
I think it was an inside job.
Yeah.
Do you actually?
I don't blame anyone either way for what they think. I wouldn't like ridicule anyone either way, to be honest.
I would blame people either way if they started to use it as a political way of getting up on someone else.
Oh, yeah.
He's just using it as a
conversation. I'm not saying, you're not trying to gain office. Do you know
what
I mean? Yeah.
Right, I'm not going for a presidency.
Yeah, thankfully you might in the future. Though.
Yeah. Well, maybe. Calfreezy for 2045.
I can actually see you as an old man, as a good prime minister or president.
No. He's
God, Calfreezy.
Sorry,
you
can't even
go.
Who wants a night out?
So, Cal, it's actually the main reason we got you down here
was to ask you if you wanted to become president.
I mean, it's mainly just, why weren't we invited back to commentate on the side?
Oh, well, as a member of the...
Will is playing.
As a future member of the Sidemen.
I tell you what, there is a price you can pay. I mean, from what I've heard, Will's put, you know, a cheeky bit of, you know, cash in the back.
I feel
he's making so much.
That's what I've been told.
Do you remember when Keys and Grey got booted off of Sky Sports? I feel like that. Do you know what I mean?
And we are Keys and Grey.
It was just banter. It was just banter.
I thought yous were quality last year, so I was like, when I saw it, like, even from a fan perspective, I was
like...
So
we just get two fuckboys to take over, what do you think the deal is?
who are coming on the podcast soon.
Oh, I'm joking.
No, but the point is, I actually think it is quite a good idea to get Joe and Elliot, because actually they're quite a good combination. Yeah. And it's the perfect people to get in.
You text me, and that's the first thing I said was, it's a good idea, because I can't be arsed with all the parents and fucking under 10-year-olds tweeting me about swearing again. Right. So fucking crack on.
You did rinse them on that podcast. You were literally reading them up, be like, fuck off, and then just do whoever like rinsed you.
So all I want to know was which member of the Sidemen made the call to have me removed.
It was Mini Minter.
You know him well.
It was actually Will. Will said, "There can only be one Geordie on this broadcast."
it's my fault. Yeah,
it was in his contract. It's the main issue. No, because ultimately it's quite funny to play jokes about, because it's not going to be an editorial.
There'll be some people out there.
Otherwise, we'd be invited back.
There'll be some people out there who genuinely think we're like fucking raging about it.
I'm going away on holiday now.
Charity, mate. I mean, I'd rather be doing something that makes us money, not giving away stuff for free. Really?
I mean, it's a great.
I'm sick of doing stuff for free. When am I getting paid? Huh?
I mean, to be fair, you absolutely rinsed that feed for as
many.
I'd say you did pretty well out of it, to be honest.
Well, mate, 25,000 subscribers in 24 hours.
Some people
generally considered good.
You should give all those subscribers to charity.
Yeah, Africans could eat those.
That's inconsiderate. I mean, that's disgusting.
Cannibals. Cannibals. We'll leave that in.
Wow.
Put that in.
I don't want to be that guy. Could you pass the next bottle of white wine over?
Sure.
Yeah, we're also going to have that. We're going to start doing...
the one on the left.
A phrase actually, we never thought we'd hear on the podcast, actually. Yeah.
We're going to...
next bottle of white wine over.
Both will do.
Screw top.
We're going to start doing like quotes where we put pictures out of what people have said on the podcast. Yeah, when they say something profound or deep, and then put the actual person who said it. So the first one I'm going to do is... Africans could eat your 24,000 subscribers, WillNE.
I thought I would have 2017.
Yeah, I was going to say it's
25.
You just lyric now so you don't have to donate that extra thousand.
I'm putting down a thousand. I hope you wouldn't notice, but it's.
Do you ever think in the future we'll look back on this time and just think, the fuck were we doing?
Yeah, well, I hope we would do that.
I hope not. I hope I'm still doing it. I want to keep getting pissed. No, I mean, with like, you know, like putting it out on YouTube.
In 500 years' time.
Right.
When history's being taught, or you
this
know,
was entertainment.
They'll be like, "What were they doing?" You know.
I hope that
that took a deep turn.
I don't mean that in terms of
Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. I hope people look back on me and you like Bill and Ted are.
Right.
Like they started it all.
Bodacious. Yeah.
I guarantee you, me and Will are like, who the fuck are
Bill? Oh, you're not Bill and Ted.
Sorry, you knew who Peter Mandelson was, but you don't know who Bill and Ted.
Not Bill and Ted.
Peter Mandelson.
Keanu Reeves' first film.
I know him.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Be you excellent to each other.
You actually look a bit like Bill and Ted.
Bill and Ted.
We look nothing like Bill and Ted.
Yeah, one's light hair, one's
Do you know who they are?
You do look a bit like Keanu Reeves, though.
Yeah.
That is.
Oh, okay. I could be down for that.
Yeah?
I don't know. I know he is.
What do you mean you don't know who Keanu Reeves is?
I know he is, but I like all I know is that he's got dark hair, so I feel like that's all. You've just picked that out of the box.
He is the one.
Pretty much.
I am like Morpheus. I picked them out of Newcastle.
You are.
And I was like, he is the one.
Yeah.
Which pill?
Mm. Which pill?
Which pill? That was when Chip came in and went, I've got the pills. I don't know if Chip does pills.
If you'd gone...
Where did you tear that from?
If you'd gone to the party, you'd know him.
I was going
to
say,
he's just fucking
dick. For about an hour in, his career's been ruined.
Sorry,
like
sorry, mate. I mean, he's a good clean living lad. He likes the odd drink.
You fully have to get him on after this to like defend himself.
I hope so. That's what I do.
He needs a chance to defend himself.
Bait him in.
Yeah.
You should get Jay on as well. I mean, the girl.
I just got and said the name. Oh, he's completely fucked it there. Everyone's rewinding the podcast. What was the name?
I think I said her name earlier anyway, to be honest. But, Jay, thanks for watching. Appreciate all me female members of the public.
Of the, Much the love. True Sorry. Clan.
Yeah, I mean, we haven't really got a name for that.
Geordies. All the Geordies.
Jay's a lovely girl. I've met her, actually. She's very polite.
When did you meet her?
He came to film at my flat.
I filmed at his flat.
Oh, of course, yeah.
Nice.
To be fair, though, she does keep the place a lot cleaner than you do.
Yeah. Well, it's the same thing, though, isn't it?
I think that's quite a good combination.
Our place
smelt
so bad when you came to film.
Yeah.
Like, that bin smelt really bad.
No. Go and tell him what happened and just hope G hasn't got to this point, because I remember you told me once he'd left, you found the reason why it smelt so bad.
That filthy condom.
Was the,
curry?
Yeah, it had spilt on the floor.
What happened?
So, there was bin, was the bin bags there when you...
Oh, there was bin bags,
Because you've got to go all the way downstairs to like take your bins out, haven't you? Well, I'd fully spilt the curry on the floor, but like through bin bags, and we leave the bin bags there for at least 3 days.
You're living in a luxury
condo. It's like fully stained this like floor, and it's like just bright
Which
yellow.
G doesn't know about, actually. That's why I bring it up, because had she known about it, he would have been fucked, but now that she will know about it.
She's not that much better than me, to be honest. Ooh. Like, she's genuine. Like, credit to her, right? Wow. She might have chip on strings, but she doesn't get on you fair.
I could do with someone to help me edit gaming.
No, but he's actually
a sound guy.
Yeah, he's a really sound. But not only did he help me. So the way it works is, I was getting so irritated with editing videos to the point where I would rush it and it would come out not how I'd want it. Just purely for the fact I hated editing videos. So I brought in this guy. Like, really brought in loads of new ideas, loads of fresh things. It turns out as well, so I initially it was just an editor, and then he was actually very good at using cameras and sort of, you know, directing things, I suppose. So what I ended up doing was, now we're just sort of like a duo team, and he helps out with loads of that sort of stuff, makes the video look nicer. And then what we do is we both sit down and we, like, I know it sounds quite weird, but we like edit videos together. So he'll do a big chunk of it, he'll be like, what do you think to this? And then I'll go through and I'll nitpick everything I don't like, we'll swap it all out, and that way I'm getting a video that I'm really happy with, and I've had input in, and he's done like,
I've learned how to edit through understanding comic timing, but I have no idea of the inner workings of fucking Premiere Pro and things. Professionals are there for a reason.
Yeah, that's like a different dimension to it, isn't it?
Why is there any shame in someone getting Jay to edit a video?
No, I'm not saying there's any shame. I'm just saying it's a not a known thing. So I didn't know.
But why? No. But I think the thing is, because YouTube is very much a self. When you look at a channel, you see one person, and this is their channel.
And I think the big appeal to YouTube is that people see that and think, I could do that because one person's doing all that. Like, they learn editing, I could learn editing. But then
so it's a lie.
When you learn, fully. When you learn that there's actually a team or like
so
a couple of people behind
that.
Hard.
The thing is.
It's not a shameful thing when you get in there.
Yeah,
like,
but the thing is,
I've been, when you do it
for like six, 7 years now, it comes a time where, you don't want to edit videos. You know, you can do what I do. You know, it's possible. Like, you look at my videos, the editing isn't like I'm throwing in all these crazy effects or anything. It's nothing like that, but it's literally just come down to it where I literally could not put myself through taking time to go over my videos and things like that. And that's why you bring someone else in, and then you have a video you're happy with.
Fully, and sometimes editing your own videos, like, it does hold you back. Like, people will get better content. Like, your audience will get better content if you employ an editor, because you don't have to put that time to it, so you can film more, because all you're really needed for is to be on
screen. If I could get an editor to do it cheap enough for us, I'd be fucking delighted.
They're probably going to get 1,000 emails now, but do you think that
actually, if you can edit videos, I'm interested. Just
do you think that is part
cheaper than these lads do, preferably, because I mean, expensive.
Do you think now you've got to put pictures over do you think it is a problem that people don't know that someone else edit someone else's video?
So, from a YouTuber's perspective, I think it is absolutely not a big deal at all. But from an audience perspective, I feel like they would kick off by reason.
So surely it's a problem from the YouTuber's perspective as well, right? Because YouTube is built on the idea that...
But what they're doing isn't bad. I just feel like people might misconceive it as a bad thing. As in, like...
Do you think that having a girl edit videos for lads makes it any different at all?
Absolutely not. No, why the hell would that make a difference?
No, I'm just saying, you know, some people perceive things.
Some people are sexist, then, but I don't really worry about that.
Without a doubt, they are.
But at the same time, you'd also say maybe some people have a different perception of humour, so you might end up with a different edit.
Because
every editor, you're going to end up with a different edit.
You've got to like train them.
It's interesting you bring that up, is because when I set out to look for this other person, a lot of times they were like, oh, well, you know, this established guy, he's been doing it for 3 or 4 years, blah, blah. And I instantly was like, actually, I don't want anyone with any sort of real corporate experience. I went straight to university and I hired straight through universities, purely because I know that people in unis have similar humor. No, they have similar humor to me.
Walked into that.
Similar humor to me, so they get the jokes. They know what the current memes
are. Younger.
That's a good show.
So I went straight over there, and then also when it becomes an editor, because I upload, you know, well, at the moment about once a week, but you know, at the time it was supposed to be like two. You don't need them on a full time basis if they're just editing, and that's what he originally started doing. Was it, you don't need them, so you know, we just part time.
And another thing is, there's a lot to be said for employing people if you're able to, because you're spreading. Yeah, like the joy. Do you know what I mean?
Well,
like
very small fraction.
People out there coming out of university are struggling. Struggling like fuck coming out of uni these days. And if a YouTuber or someone else can help them out, good fucking all power to them.
Calfreezy improving the economy.
Well, I do what I can.
Cheers to Calfreezy.
Hey, I'll toast to
cheers,
that.
Everyone.
I might be left over in the corner. Yeah.
To be fair, you just walked away and sipped in the other direction. Isn't it weird?
Still.
He has to get in proper jobs, champion.
Real jobs.
I enjoy this.
That went really well.
Nice one. So, how's this red wine looking? Then there's a.
You're doing all right.
You're cracking through there. Like,
Merlot is, I mean, I've got no idea, but it's going down nicely.
It's very smooth, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. The other one's a bit too fruity for me. Yeah. I thought it'd be nice, but it's harsh.
It's too fruity.
It's like
fruity.
Paint thinner.
Gallo is.
Have you drank from this cup?
Would it matter? I mean, can I have a cup?
Can I have a cup from it, please?
Yes.
Can I promise
yes.
I'm going for red. I'm not going to lie. You know, if you're getting into wine, I would recommend starting with white.
Maybe white.
Just if you're getting into it.
You know, if you're just starting off.
Have you been into wine before? Will.
Well, I mean, if
Will,
I'm
that's
green,
a, that's a lot of wine to be getting into something.
I bet you that couldn't go through anything. Cool, cool. I bet you can have anything.
Wow. Will.
Actually, that's a lie. I've been on nights out with him. He can't have it.
All right.
I'm lying. Try it, Will. Just tell us, if you sniff that.
Which one? You go for a summary.
Can we make this like a professional thing where you like swill it and
sniff that and tell us what you get?
It's just Wayne, isn't it, though, isn't it?
No, come on, man. Don't be a dick.
That's exactly what I expected.
Oh, it's fruity. Like, yeah, that's what you said.
But what kind of fruit? What kind of fruit?
Oh, just don't be a knob. And fruit.
Orange and grapes.
Yeah, it doesn't say on the back, really. Yeah, just fruity. Yeah, well done. You got fruit.
That's genuinely nice.
You're good at wine. Turns out.
I was always a cultured individual.
Yeah.
What about them CPMs, lads?
Oh my god. Right.
This is going on in YouTube, so we should probably talk about it.
My community really
so
bad.
Drama alert has been talking about. So basically,
did you see what they do?
I don't know what Coca Cola and a few other companies have pulled out of advertising YouTube.
Yeah, so
what that means is the average person making money off of YouTube's money has gone down quite a lot.
So it's funny for different YouTubers because some YouTubers who rely on fully on your view, like the CPM, you're pretty much fucked. But a lot of YouTubers can just rely on brand deals because it turns the rest of it into it. Yeah. But do you see what Keeman Scarce did? Being like, oh, hashtag thank you Coke is like a big push. Being like, oh, we'll save YouTube by promoting the brands that stuck in with their adverts. They made this big thing being like, oh, thank you Coke. Like everyone go buy a Coke because they're still advertising. Posted the video and then Coke pulled their ads like 6 hours later.
Brilliant.
So it's like, to be fair, I'll not say bad things.
If maybe Fanta Fruit Twister watching this, we would love her.
Oh, I love Fanta Fruit Twister.
Wait, who's Fanta owned by, though?
I think Coke. Yeah.
Coke.
Yeah.
All right, then.
So, I'm still on that train.
Love you, Fanta.
Yeah, but
I love the brothers, the Coke brothers.
But what I don't understand, is why the hell is there not a beer sponsor, a wine sponsor,
a gambling sponsor,
like everything that you shouldn't get involved in life needs to be a sponsor of this thing. Would you not agree?
Like, do you know what it is? I'm going to clip that up.
Cut that up.
Put that on fucking Instagram. Tag every fucking
every gentleman's club in the north.
Wait. So why did Coke pull?
Spearmint Rhino, where the fuck are you?
Why have all these advertisers put on?
I know the owner.
It's because they were getting put on hate speech without their consent, so YouTube wasn't monitoring enough what they were putting onto those ISIS videos, those heavily, heavily right-wing videos that they were putting.
But then what they've done, they've been over the top with that intake, and they've, because of a few daft idiots, it's ruined it for everyone.
Isn't that how the world works?
As soon as I saw that, I'm like, YouTube are going to go way too far and start demonetizing videos that don't need it. Like, I have friends in more the commentary community where it's a little bit more edgy, where they're like, my full channel's been demonetized here. Like, every video I've made
for
in 8 month period.
Because people literally can't pay the fucking bills out of nowhere.
Like,
you've literally had the rug pulled out from underneath you.
So, it's weird though.
It's like when Thatcher got the miners.
Oh, here we go. Now we're going
Yeah, except we actually all need coal.
Yeah, this wine is actually...
I'm not going into this.
Right? We do a good service to the community.
It's weird, though. Over the last few months, I've really taken like a sort of backseat to views, the CPM. I didn't even know the CPM thing was
really?
He doesn't give a fuck this.
No. It's not because
he's
of that.
He's still living off FIFA coin money, this cunt, man. That's FIFA 14 still paying this cunt, honestly.
But it's weird, though, because you'll find a lot of YouTubers actually become very obsessive and almost addictive. It's very easy to become like that. And it happened to me. It happened to someone. And it honestly, like, I know a lot of YouTubers. As soon as a video goes live, they want to watch the real time. They want to see how it's peaking.
Well, it couldn't be like that.
No. But a lot, you'll be amazed. Like, so many YouTubers go through this. And for me, I couldn't tell you what my last video was. And some people are like, oh, you just don't care anymore. Well, it's actually because I don't want to be in a shit mood because a video has done
poorly.
And you
stop caring about the content as much as you want.
Because you're like, oh, this doesn't do very good views, so I'm actually going to go
do this.
Whereas
you can easily go, oh, I'll go easy views. I'll put some boobs in the thumbnail. And then, like, it's not the same
you
level.
Just, you, yeah, for me especially, I just figured out, you know what? Is it otherwise, you're either going to be a shit mood, okay, you're in a great mood, and then you just have this horrible roller coaster.
It completely controls. Like, I remember you taking a piss out. I tweeted it once, but it controls your mood. Like, you can be like, I'm having a really good week, and then you drop a video that you think's dead good, and it, like, do the half the normal views, and you're like, this is like, I've been miserable for the last 3 years.
I must admit, because we did a couple of podcasts lately where, like, I don't know, we had the doctor on, who the cosmetic
which I
doctor.
Watched, which was fucking his voice amazing. Was
mad.
Although I tell you what, I actually thought about this, because when you asked me to come on, I was like, I need to mention this to him. Mm-hmm. He said, you know, so many times, and it didn't bug me so much. It didn't bug me. Yeah, it didn't bug me, and it was exactly. And it was an amazing pause, and I still loved it. But I picked up on it about halfway through, and I was just like, oh whoa, like.
The one thing I've realized about podcasts, and I realized about other podcasts as well, is when you're speaking for 2 hours at a time, especially every week, if it's me and Laurence, every bad habit that you have is out there. Like, and we all have bad habits. Everyone watching who's nitpicking at the bad habits on there, the fact that you're nitpicking is also a bad habit about you as well. Like, and
or it's a flipped.
No, it's true.
No, it is. The fact that it bothers you enough to leave a comment is a bad habit you've got yourself, because you kind of just let shit lie. But at the same time,
if that
doctor is there. He probably has a way about talking to put people at ease, because he's getting people to strip off naked who are probably feeling a bit self-conscious. So he goes, you know that you are. And what he's trying to do is make them. He's probably trying to make them feel better about a situation. So he's gotten a habit of saying that.
Yeah.
And every person that we've had on, we've had comments about something that they do all the time.
Yeah. Idiosyncrasies that they have.
Well, yeah, because on a 10-minute video, like what we usually do, our 5-minute video, it's all cut down, and you don't really get to see what they're like, just chilling. But on a podcast, there's nothing to hide. Mm-hmm. So all the, like he says, essentially, and things like that quite a lot.
Well, because I like to it's very essence, that's what I mean. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Very often I can't say a sentence.
But we find words that we say instead of saying, we find ways to fill that space
if
in.
If you listen to my early radio, a lot of it was...
Well, Nick Yaris, the guy who did Death
God,
Row,
yeah.
Well, he told me...
Death Row.
Was... He literally never did the... Because every word he said was measured. And then after that podcast, I thought... I need to stop doing that, because I don't want to sound like I'm not sure about what I'm saying.
When's that going to kick in?
I'm trying. I'm giving a time.
You actually, funny you should be, because when I watched this, the doctor one, and I saw that he said, you know, like quite a bit.
Was it? Yeah,
I then I started to, it's weird, because then I started like, okay, so what do the other guys do any of this at all? Yeah. And then at that time you said you used the word like quite a bit.
That's quite northern.
Do you know what I mean?
That's a northern thing.
It doesn't take away from the bug, but then I was like, oh, it's so interesting that all these people, and if you look at my my early videos, you see it everywhere, and I'm just like, oh my, this is quite awful.
But do you think you've sewn that out because you've had comments saying that you say it a lot?
No. I think not because of comments, but just purely because you get more comfortable you just feel more sort of I think the word is just comfortable. Once you're comfortable,
confidence is huge.
It's so important. And but the thing is, when you say like you said, that is because of you back in Newcastle, and it's a thing that you're like cultured.
We finish sentences
it's
with
like and right are the two things that everyone's like, why do you say that so much? Like, I go sit down to edit, and I'm like, look, this is a 3-minute period, and I've said the word right 56 times. Like, I'm gonna have to cut this out, like, because people just
that must annoy the fuck out of you.
Oh, that's why you say like perfectionist shit. That's why it's just so measured, because I just get rinsed if I don't do it.
Because you on your videos do critical pieces. People in your audience who enjoy that,
you've got to be like this critical of you. You've got to be this. You can't have a fault about you because you're criticizing someone. Mm. So you've got to be so careful with what you do.
I think it's good to have faults. Me, I think it's good to just be.
I think it's more just it's about accepting those faults. So if someone does come at you about those faults, then because you know not everyone's perfect, not everyone's you, Brian, but.
I'm just very comfortable with my fault.
Everyone's,
like, I ended up in a... I thought about this, the whole Dapper Laughs thing, and after we had him on, and he sort of took the approach of being quite... like a little bit like he was a victim of what had happened, although he did also hold his hands up. Mm. I don't think I would be a victim in that situation. I would actually say, yeah, I fucking said it. What's your problem?
I think
because I am so accepting of who I am as a person that I'm not going to let anyone... have a go at that.
It's quite, I mean? It's quite a good approach to take, but at the same time,
it's dangerous.
It's quite a media trained approach. Approach that Dabba Laf's had.
I mean, for sure, but I think what he had was more of a resistant approach. I imagine if you have so many people like me coming at you or trying to talk to you about it, in the end, you're almost going to glaze over a little bit, or you're going to get very good at having defense things, which very easily
almost like an answer machine message.
Yeah, it's like,
yeah, and that was what I was very cynical about, and what I sort of was surprised about that podcast. But then you realize. What I found weird about that podcast was not many people were actually evaluating the content of what we were saying. It was about the overall tone of what he was saying, what the overall tone of what I was saying was. So
because you sound like, it's not even what the words are coming out. It's
people didn't care. Whereas with him,
you just want to see other people's having a good time when they watch a video. Like they just want it to be
What I wanted to do is not sit there and bullshit a guy. Instead, if I've got a problem with someone, you'd rather that you said it than me sit there and be like,
but what people don't realize is me and you both made an agreement before that podcast that when he comes on we have to give a fair and balanced argument, and we agreed that you would be the one to ask him the challenging
questions.
We agreed
it would be a little hypocritical if you were the one then going,
if I'm sitting there going to double ass, can't believe you've said this, that and the other, when I say worse than him a lot for the most of the time, apart from the stuff that he said with the rape stuff.
Even then,
all right,
just off camera.
But we made that agreement, and you, to be fair, you got a lot of the shit for that. But I take just as much criticism out of that because this was our agreement. We decided it was going to go down like that, and if we get the grief, I'll stick up like I did on Twitter and say,
yeah, of course.
When people are saying Laurence is unprofessional, I'm like, you haven't got a clue.
But ultimately, you got a better show out of that anyway, because you were digging deep instead of just being like, oh yeah, we'll all debate on this podcast for 2 hours. Like you were asking the real questions that people would have wanted to see. So
what I do find interesting, and you guys probably have this with your audience, you know why your audience is watching, but early on in your YouTube life, I think a lot of people assume why their audience is watching.
And don't really
and a lot of people you sit in a room with, especially media guys or big people at the top, assume or tell you why your audience is watching. And actually, I realized a lot of audiences on YouTube watch for comfort, or they watch because they've got like someone they really like.
Yeah, like,
so they don't like to see you being argued with.
Or any arguing at all.
Or any arguing.
Because that is your escape from the shit at home. Like, we all have moments where we're at home and someone's doing my head in. And YouTube is the place where you go out of that and you have a chill out moment. You have someone make you laugh.
But also with YouTube, you watch the person, you feel more of a connection than you would if you were watching someone on TV.
Exactly.
So then if you come on his channel and then stop, you know what I mean?
It's like challenging.
It's a different
audience. Some people are going to watch you completely to have their views confirmed. Like, there's going to be a likelihood that there's a massive amount of your subscribers that watch because they agree with what you say, be that as a character or be that when you're in the moment.
Well, they're
angry.
Football fans who, you know, they like a good time and they're probably a bit like me. But
you know what I mean? There's going to be a percentage of those people. But then there's also going to be a percentage of people who watch the podcast for the other reason. But it's really interesting to see why people, it's fascinating to see people in the comments. People in the comments really go at it.
Yeah,
I like that though because I like that people care enough to I don't like it when I don't mind me and you getting criticised. You can handle that, I can handle that. But when people go overboard with it, whether it be you or me, I'm like, don't be silly, man.
What I found sad was I don't mind someone from the right wing having a go at someone on the left wing.
Yeah, it's part of it. It's part of the.
Well, that's a YouTuber.
I'm interested in the right wing at the moment. Like, I'm interested in why they've gained so much traction. Like, what's got them there? I don't necessarily think it's their message, but I think there are elements of what they say which is good. Anyway, it doesn't matter. This guy commented 2 weeks before on the Dapper last video. When the terror attacks happened in London...
God, this was true.
This guy went 2 weeks back to go to that video and comment below, the blood of the people who died today are on your hands because left-wing people like you defend terrorists. And I remember getting that...
Laurence McKenna kills 5 people in London. Like, it's
and I remember sitting there and just thinking...
We could actually Photoshop you behind... No,
I genuinely remember thinking...
I've just said it now, so...
That's really sad that like that someone's first thought is not, wow, that's really fucking awful.
It's but it's comments.
I'll go to YouTube and make sure. And my point
that shows how bothered he was by it. But so, like I say, I like that people care, but there's a line in there. Like,
but it's about why you care and what you do with that caring. And a lot of people think it's just about the caring itself. It's about what that caring then causes you to do, which matters. Mm. It's like people say, I love you, but it's like, I love you, all right, then do something about it. Do you know what I mean? It can't just be like, I love you, and therefore whatever you do is good.
Well, the problem with the YouTube comments in general is that it's very rare that someone's going to be chilling out watching your video, watching Will's video, anyone, and leave a comment just saying, loving this, having a great time, da da da. Like, and those people are the fucking true MVPs of YouTube.
Yeah.
To me, those people right who are sitting. Like,
everyone dropping the comments.
No, but it's true though, so because true. They're rare people. Because yeah. and we all are guilty of this. It's very when you're sitting watching a YouTube video and you're enjoying it. Like, I watch Joe Rogan's podcast a lot, and then you
just quit.
Very rarely will I like the video or leave a comment. It's not because I don't like the video. It's my relaxing time. Yeah. So I don't want to have to think about anything. I just put it on and I'm playing on the Xbox or PlayStation or whoever sponsors us in future. Mm. And I'm thinking to myself,
GameCube. We love GameCube.
But when someone pisses me off, I'm more likely to pick the phone and go, you're fucking Belen.
Yeah. That's so interesting.
And we are all like that. I think I
do the opposite.
No, but
I'll drop a like on a video. And like, I love Jimmy Conrad's videos. I comment below all them because I'm like, I really want to support this guy, why wouldn't you?
Do either of you?
But I'm saying the regular people are like that.
Too. So when I
watch your videos, the first thing I'll do is I'll be like, right, I like Cal, therefore I want to show support for him. Thumbs up.
See, but what I would do instead is maybe tweet that person on Twitter, and because I think it's more of a personal thing on Twitter. Yeah. Whereas still on YouTube, I like even with my comments, I might look at the first three highest rated ones, and that's purely because exactly the reason you said in the center is just filled with so much negativity. Mm. And it doesn't actually reflect the content that you create.
But I'm not doing it for you to see. So I'm not doing it so that you go into your comments below and think, oh, thank God really? For that. Yeah. And at the same time, I think if someone saw me tweeting something about you, they'd just be like, well, he's clearly doing that so that if Cal sees it,
he's looking off or something like that.
Because they'll think of that. So what I'm doing it for is so I understand where my place is on YouTube. First of all, if you click the thumbs up, apparently that helps. Secondly, if you comment on, apparently that helps. Right. But then you're also just giving something positive. If someone else who cares about your channel is scrolling through, they'll be like, I got enjoyment out of this too. I like that.
See, I feel like that's a really mature mindset to bring to YouTube.
But that's not YouTube.
But you can try.
So whereas like, if Brian, like, he'll message me, he's like, I've really enjoyed your video with Will. Mm-hmm. I'll be like, that's really, but he'll message me that privately.
Yeah.
And I think I would almost appreciate that more than if he had commented it on
because
my YouTube video.
Because
it's personal, and it's like, Cal, I really liked it. I was like, oh shit, he actually means it because he took his time out to get off of that platform and go message me privately and be like, by the way, Cal, that video was really good.
Which is interesting.
But when you're happy, lads, you're content. And when you're content, you very rarely feel the urge to voice anything.
You're generally
just happy. But when you're pissed off, you're much more likely to just want to voice that opinion. And that is the YouTube comments. In a nutshell.
Do either of you two like police your comments? Do you ever like go through? See, I remember talking to you about 3 weeks ago being like, I don't read them. And then recently I've just started being like, look, I'm going to go through them. And if there's something that's like unnecessarily negative or just like personal attack, I'll just get rid of it. And then I found that my comments got much nicer because of that, because like negativity breeds negativity. Yeah. So then if you go like start replying to the positive ones or you start promoting the positive ones, suddenly there's this big shift. You think, oh shit. So like they're not perceiving this and a different way. It's just like, it's how you control how the comment section works.
Some people also think it's banter. Like some guys just go into the comments below to say something and they think it's funny. Like they're probably with a mate and they'll be like, what's the funniest thing you can think to say?
Let's call them a squarehead
and
nonce.
And on the other end, you're like, oh, a squarehead nonce. But on their end, they're like, Will will love that. He tweets out. And the platform stops you from seeing that. Like I want a video. What I want is a function on YouTube where you can watch a video, but resentfully.
Come on.
So I don't like some people's comment, but I don't want them. But some people say to me like, "Oh, you need to go and watch this," and I'll be like, "But I fucking hate
so
that."
You
channel.
Can do that. You just turn ad block on. That's
what it's right. Okay. Just put a.
That's like the slide.
Enough of that.
But what I want is a resentful watching. Yeah, don't talk about that fucking industry.
Come on.
What I want is a resentful button so you can watch other people's content, but it show up as a bad view. Like a negative view.
Laurence McKenna did not like this video.
Yeah. So at the end of the video, I'll be like, because
watched this in anger.
Yeah, exactly.
You should become like a critic, like just write articles on videos you've watched.
Who gives a fuck about that? That would actually be really funny. What if you started critically?
If you started like writing a review of a YouTube video,
as if anyone gives a fuck. I'll let
you
know.
My bowels are a lot better than they were 5 minutes ago.
That's a
massive relief. Not my. Oh no. What's the other one for?
Bladder.
For piss.
Bladder.
My bladder is.
Fresh out of school.
To be fair, right? I stopped doing biology
so
in year 9.
Funny.
So you stopped doing biology.
How many of those have you had?
Yeah. Well, I have a thing where I like faint of blood. So like, I have a condition where like, if in a gory situation, I know this is like a big thing.
Wait,
well, not
what?
So I have a condition where if I'm in a gory situation, don't laugh.
Wait, in a gory, as in you see someone
in
else bleeding
in a stressful
situation,
like my brain shuts down the blood flow to my head, so I just pass out. Like I've passed out like my life. So
in a stressful
I didn't do biology,
situation.
So I mean. That's
so in a stressful situation.
Yeah. So like you know my exam, like my exams for like GCSE and A level, I got like extra time for a gym. It's decent. It was decent.
Did you pass out? Wait, did you pass out in the middle of those?
I haven't passed out in an exam yet.
Okay.
Well, I don't think it's really a thing. But like it's just I would feel like really close to about going. Yeah.
Let him talk.
No,
but you keep interrupting. I'm just thinking to myself.
Yeah.
Can you give us some examples of ways that you've passed
where
out?
Where have I passed out? So the first one, Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. You know that big snake thing? Not fully. Yeah, no, basilisk. I was in year two. Allow us, yeah? So I was like about eight and they put this thing through it and I was like, I hit the deck and my parents are like, oh fuck, he's like epileptic or something. They took it and I was like, nah. Something like, yeah. I know it's a madness. I've never talked about that on YouTube. So that's an exclusive.
Else? When else?
So just like, when you know you'd be in school and
so
they show
excited
like a
to
gory
lose
video.
His virginity and he's like oh yeah. Fuck
well yeah
no. I was good with that you know
you did like, that
yeah
anything nice, with women bro.
It's fine when I'm at home, it's more when I'm like out or I was at a cinema at school, like it's a stressful situation like
so public speaking. If you had to do something for YouTube,
nah, I'm gone. Speaking I haven't passed out in the last 10 years. It was just a thing when I was growing up.
All right.
So I was mad. But anyway.
Wow. Do you think you've grown out of it? Or?
Oh, yeah, fully.
Okay.
Yeah, massively. Well, I mean, if it was a really bad situation, I'd probably hit the deck. Like,
so
I'm
you
not
should probably do GCSEs now.
Oh, yeah, it might be pretty decent. Yeah.
Should we do emails?
Mm. What I did want to ask is what music do you two listen to?
We have quite a similar taste.
Yeah, we have similar taste. Like but mine is also like, so the only two things that I won't really listen to is sort of the heavy metal and the screamo sort of thing, and then also like the classical and the you know very instrumental sort of things where there's no lyrics over it.
How come you ask?
But yeah,
I was just wondering. You both seem like guys who are quite into music.
We're both quite into.
Yeah, we have very similar.
Yeah, yeah. I do sometimes because my dad really enjoys like metal and stuff like that. So I was brought up on that as well. So there's like two sides of it, but I. Finally, my music taste is very varied. I know that's like a cliche answer. No. But
What's your dad's first name? Or am I not allowed?
Simon.
Simon, that's
big man.
Shout out to Big Size.
Mini Minter.
He watches these, to be fair. I think he subscribes to me, you, and Stephen Tries.
Speaking of which, I got a phone call from my mum about a week after this went up. And do you remember we talked about the divorce?
Yeah. Mm.
Your divorce. And I spoke about how they. And she just called up to say, like, it was. Because I'd never spoken to her really about it.
Right.
But this was the most I'd spoken about it, like, before. Public. Oh, no. Even privately,
right.
In a sense, well, I suppose I speak to friends, but like, and she just called and she was like, it was great to hear like your thoughts on it and like all this sort of stuff. And I was like, that's actually pretty cool.
Like, do you know what it is? Like, I'm getting a bit like, I feel like really good about that.
I was glad as well because I mean, I had no problem. I could have told my
but
mom
you
that
can
anyway,
imagine
but
from her perspective, hearing that publicly that you were okay about everything,
yeah,
would have made her feel like. Oh well, considering that was a tough thing to go through.
Yeah,
I did me job well.
So thanks, guys. Huh? I appreciate that. You made my mum feel a lot
shout
better.
Out to
bringing
True
families podcast, together. Yeah? The True Geordie.
This Mama Freezy.
As I normally divide them, but you know.
She'll be watching this one. I know she'll watch this one. She watches like.
No, honestly, videos. God bless. Wow. I thought she was great on your video with you.
Yeah, well, she's actually me and her have like a very similar sense.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
Like you said, you can tell.
Right.
You can tell you're related.
Which is great. That's a real plus. That's a real plus. Anyways, did you say emails?
Do you want to do some emails?
Yeah.
Laptop, man. Have you still got the tape across it from last time?
Oh no.
Oh, we are showing all the brands.
Brand deal central.
Hi, Steve Jobs. Message me.
It's basically.
I keep emailing. He doesn't email back.
That's weird.
It's basically only betting companies that'll touch us, so, you know, who knows.
Yeah, wait, so what's wrong with that, though?
Yeah.
Oh, betting companies, more than welcome, there's just only so many of them, unfortunately.
Because I'll let you know that betting companies, they are fantastic to work with. Like, fantastic.
Look at that.
Oh, shit, BetSafe took you on gumball,
looking
didn't
at that. You know the emoji with the fucking dollar signs in the eyes? He's just
are you talking about BetSafe? I mean,
sorry, what was that?
Yeah, fully.
Anyways.
Basically, he got treated quite well.
Talking about Rebel FC.
Whoa,
you
don't
go
500, thanks.
That
what
much.
We got going on?
I can't believe
it's
we haven't
not
talked
about
this.
Actually,
never
mind.
So, it's not
Leonardo. It's recently been released.
Wait, why do you enlarge it? Are you blind?
No, just so that I don't lose my place is way more difficult. Like, if you're reading from a distance, in radio, you're supposed to print it out, in double the size and then double the spacing.
Used to be a professional, you see.
What do you mean used to
that
be?
That just seems
still
silly.
Is.
It seems a bit... over the top, but whatever. If it works for you, it works for you. Anyways, so we have Harvey Wright.
You know,
Has he taken the job?
Yeah, but you can't say the name.
Harvey Wrong.
Yeah, good.
And he says, "Hi guys, I'm a 15-year-old boy who has recently been released by Birmingham Academy. Do you want to sign up to a Rebel FC? And then since then, I've had no offers from any big clubs, and the only offers I have got are from small teams, Sheffield Wednesday, and other teams, or from teams that are non-league. Yeah. I'm in a I'm a tricky right winger." You know, not left winger, like my guy over here. Come on. Anyways, who loves to cut inside on my left foot. Thanks for your help. So it's a long story short, this guy's just got cut from an academy. He plays on the wing.
Well, it's a good job we've got football experience here, isn't it? Professional football careers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What would you do if you just got cut?
Can you help him out? I mean, because you've got a bit of an
announcement. He's 15, I can't do that.
You've got a bit of an
announcement. That's a good rule of life. You know what
I mean? Yeah, I can't do that.
He needs to have all sorts of things. His council needs to...
Calfreezy FC, come with...
No.
It's just a bad thing to deal with underage kids.
Do you know what? Oh, man, I couldn't imagine like being a bit like... being a footballer and then being like cut from it, like because I'm sure like you know it is his dream to become a thing and then you get cut.
But it's gotta happen a lot. I can't success stories have that. Like, oh, I was cut from something.
But then maybe they make it again,
exactly.
Right?
Like, yeah.
Exactly. That happens all the time.
We told Luka Modric that he wasn't good enough for us.
We got Jamie Vardy who came out from
He just
I think everyone has to go through like rejection at anything they do. Do you know what I mean? Mm. So don't give up, mate.
What you're saying is you can only join the dots backwards.
I was told by previous YouTube channels that they were going in a different direction before. Yeah. Oh. And what that meant was... down, and I was on the up, so you know.
Turns out top tens are good for your channel.
So, you know, just ignore the haters, mate.
It's part of the story, isn't it?
So, should he go and like maybe trial for another club? Yeah. What should he do?
He mentioned Sheffield Wednesday, didn't he? Compared to Birmingham.
I mean, Birmingham's known as having a reasonably...
a bigger club at the moment, but I mean, in terms of position.
What I would also say is, as a young kid, there are going to be scouts everywhere. At that level, there are going to be scouts all over the place. So what you want to do is find a place you can train and get a good technical knowledge. Try and find a club where they will give you... yeah, with a good coach. Yeah. Try and find someone you can build a good relationship with.
As much game time as possible.
And learn and get some game time.
Secondly...
the thing is, Sheffield... he says, you know, Harvey Wrong has said here that from small teams like Sheffield Wednesday, as far as I'm aware, like Sheffield Wednesday isn't a small they're not a Premier League team, but they're an institution.
And apparently there's a lot of opportunities in America as well to get like in through academies and that, because I know lads who've not quite made it over here and went over there and done really well.
Are you talking about...
No, I'm not talking about anyone you know. I just know a lad from school.
There is actually a kid who plays for NYCFC now, who's a Geordie.
No, I know a kid from school who went over there. He had trials with like Newcastle and Sunderland, and then he went over there.
I might know him.
I was supposed to film a video chat about him.
He's a cool guy, apparently.
Yeah, that's what I've heard.
And secondly, I just want to say, before we move on, education... crack on with that as well, so you've got a backup plan, mate.
Well, he is 15.
Yeah,
I forget that. Yeah,
crack on with that. Make sure you get some decent, have a backup plan in case it goes tits up.
Also, I know you want to play football, but a lot of people have asked recently. I've said, what would be your advice to a young guy who wants to get into football
in any way?
Like, and a lot of people's reply is, remember, it's not just about appearing on the pitch. There are loads of other jobs in football,
it's all about doing something, isn't it? It's just like putting yourself...
I mean, look, this guy's made a fucking living out and chatting shit about it.
Completely right. So
and Brian. A couple of pints, that's all you need.
I mean, actually,
or a bottle of wine, as we do these days.
When we had Dan Hardy on, because I was a bit of a fanboy for old Dan over there, a few people did message us saying, because of me mates, remember when I used to like literally be like a proper fan,
right?
Them,
yeah.
And they were like, "Fuck me, mate! You've went from talking shit about Niall Ranger to literally interviewing the bloke who used to like cheer on during the fights and that." Yeah.
And you said, "Fuck off," or you replied, "New number, who dis?"
Yeah.
That sounded like my dad doing an old meme.
Yeah.
That's what it sounded like. Anyways, we have a new email coming in. Call me Sarah. Basically, my brother... struggle with like the way these...
We hardly ever get girls.
You have to re-edit in your mind.
Re-edit. Yeah. So yeah, I might not read them out very smoothly, but that's because they're not written very smoothly. Yeah. Anyways, basically my brother's new friend has been coming over a lot and he has taken an interest in me. Jeez. Call me Sarah. I would assume it was a girl. Every time he comes over, he tries to make moves on me and I'm not sure what I should do. Should I tell me brother?
Me brother. Well, it's just one of us then, isn't it?
It's a really great question.
One word comes to my mind. Definitely tell
not.
Him. Definitely tell him. Why?
Because if he's an honest guy, what you have to do is ask your mate if you can go for his sister. You don't just fucking bypass him.
How do you know?
But no matter what, if someone came to you and was like, can I go for his sister? I'd be like, absolutely not. You fucking out of your mind.
At which point you don't go for
it. But you have to get the okay from your mate. You don't just go over to your mate's house and go, can I come over again? Your mate's like, I guess so. You're over yesterday, but you know, you want to come over again, that's fine.
No.
The whole time he's trying to crack on to his sister. I just think if you're going to fuck your mate's sister, you have to have the okay before
that
happens.
How do you know, though, that they've not had that conversation privately and then he's just thought...
Everyone has to communicate, mate. You know what I mean?
So what you're saying is maybe go to your brother and say, do you know that he likes me?
Has anyone here ever fucked one of their mate's sisters?
No.
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 Well, okay. Raise your hand at this table if you fucked one of your friend's sisters. Right. Go ahead.
Wait, was that you raising it as well?
No, I was just going to go ahead.
No, I have.
Are you still friends with him?
Yeah.
Did you go for the permission first?
I just had a word, you know what I mean? Is it all right?
Yeah.
But considering how many people she'd had before me, it was pretty...
Jesus, you just called your friends.
So it was fine until that point.
Yeah, at the time, I mean, at the end of the day, I'm like, at least you're now with Misha's in safe hands, for fuck's sake.
Big hands.
Big safe hands. Because at the end of the day, yeah.
Should we answer the actual question? Should I tell my brother?
So yes.
I would say no.
No.
Okay.
I would say no purely because it's like, what if? Okay, so she assumes, Sarah assumes that you know, there is moves being made, but it's actually not really that deep. It's not that deep. And then he goes and tells the friend, like, oh, by the way, your friend's making moves on me. Yeah. And then all of a sudden they've lost a friendship over what maybe not being that deep a move.
Carl's deep. Carl is deep.
Do you know what I mean? Like, I would personally say no. If he tries to go, like, definitely, like, it's bait, like,
if he goes in for
the lips, then okay, go ahead, tell your brother. Right. But if it's just making moves, like, you know, he's just like flirting with you a bit, just let it slide.
Good
it
point.
Is what it is.
No, I like that. I agree with that.
Sure. But at the same time, if he is touching you, make sure you tell a parent or just anyone.
Okay, or the police.
You're saying it's a sliding scale. If he's touching her.
If it goes past a certain point and he's definitely going in for the kill, then it's time to let
I'm sorry,
you
need
know.
To talk to my brother.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Or just squeal, like shout. No,
whoa.
Don't shout anything inflammatory.
No, just shout straight away for your brother and hopefully he'll come in the room.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, cool. Okay.
Sarah? His brother?
So how is he doing this, though? I want to know, because obviously he's going out to see his brother.
He's a crusty
like, I'm going to go to the toilet.
No, it happens all the time. You go around to your best mate's house and they've got a sister. You're always just like...
But he must be making those moves in front of the brother.
No, he must be like... He must say he's just going to, like, I don't know, get a glass of milk or whatever. He's like, I'm just going to go...
In the northeast, that's part of the thing.
Yeah, four teenagers hanging out. I'm just going to go get a glass of milk, guys.
He sees her going into the kitchen. He's like, I'll be right back.
How do you even know that? How do you even know that that's a teenager? They could be 25.
They could be, but then I think it was a little unusual. I mean, even at that stage... Let's just say he could still be going to get
hopefully a 25-year-old.
My brother's sexual friend. I don't know. Maybe it's not. Maybe I think that's legal age. We'll say legal age. Just
we'll assume all off legal age.
All right, next email.
Next email.
Carl gave some sound advice here. I like that.
You nailed that.
Okay.
Wow. Hi guys and guests.
Can we?
Okay. Let's ask. What do you want to call him?
It's a guy. It's a guy.
Harrison.
Josh.
Chip. Yeah, Chip.
Oh, Chip. All right. So.
Hey, Chip.
Hey, guy. Oh, but this is a Chip, by the way.
Yeah.
Hey, guys and guests. Please don't use my real name. Don't worry, Chip. We won't use your real name. I'm 16 and was born and raised in Ireland, but have moved to Illinois in America.
Wow.
Ooh. I mean, what an interesting... Anyways, I found this girl on Snapchat and we became friends with benefits. Boom, boom, boom.
Good luck.
Would recommend.
Great single. Great music.
I met her for the first time last week in her car in an elementary school parking lot.
Okay, that's a dodgy sentence. But.
It is what it is. I was a virgin. So he was a virgin.
There's a lone sentence in the middle of that paragraph that just goes,
I was a virgin.
Brilliant.
Anyways, when we had sex, I couldn't put the condom on or put my dick in her pussy. Ooh. So she helped me with both. Fair enough. Wait, how old is he? 16? Yeah.
He was sort of like, oh, how does this work?
How does this work?
Where's the question going?
No, no, wait. Well, I guess we'll find out. All right. Yeah, I got excited and I'm positive I lasted 30 seconds longer than my first. But my friend said, keep fucking her even if you...
If I cummed.
Yeah. Even if you cummed.
Right.
Okay. So another 30 seconds later, I pulled my... Wait, so did you choose this email? Like, this is very...
No, what is interesting?
Do you want me to... Okay, I'm going to keep going for this. So another 30 seconds later, I pulled my floppy penis out of her. Mm. I was texting her later that day, and she said I lasted for 10 minutes, which I didn't understand. I met her again the next day.
This man's perception of time is terrible. This man's on some
maybe it was that bad. It sounds like she was probably just trying to make him feel bad.
He lasted 10 minutes and he was like, doesn't time fly when you're having fun?
Right, so he's like, saying he managed like a minute and she's saying 10 minutes.
Yeah.
I met with her again the next day and did practically the same thing again.
Right.
Even though I watch vids on how to last longer, she wants to hang out again, but I really don't want to. If I could last longer, I would. Please help.
I really don't want to.
No. But do you know what's so funny is the fact that, you know, he's gone back and he's done it again, and he's watched vids on how to last longer. Like, there's no, like, you know, in GTA, you have the cheat codes and a tank appears out of nowhere. Yep. You can't just do that and last longer. The key is you get the condoms with that fucking numbing cream in it, and you do that. I mean, if 30 seconds is the best you can do, then that's your alternative.
What I'd also say is she's returned after that happened.
So she's a keeper.
And is clearly giving you compliments.
For sure.
Because it's clearly not a dig to say someone lasted 10 minutes. Like,
if you're 16 especially, bro, 10 minutes
so
is
she's
a...
not having a dig. She's trying to big him up. And she's come back.
Every
and now
month.
She wants to do it again.
So what's his big problem?
What he's basically doing is bragging through an email.
He genuinely wants, because in his head, he believes he lasted 30 minutes. He wants to actually know how to last longer.
But every man has things the way something about us will put women off. Right. And the fact that
what's yours?
She is I'm a big fat cunt, so that's one thing.
One's beating around the bush.
But genuinely,
let's get that as the inspirational quote this week.
But genuinely though, every man has something where another woman, the woman that you're not with, another woman will be like, oh, I don't like that about him. But the fact that she makes him feel better about that,
that's awesome.
A keeper. Yeah. So she's a good girl.
She's a keeper.
She's a shake-given.
He says that, she wants to hang out again, but I really don't want to. Mate, you should really
want to. Hold her. The next one, he's got this massive opportunity. Like, he might be shit now, but, he could... I don't want to use that,
bro.
But he could use that to learn and grow bigger.
Another thing is, I mean, stamina is something I don't really struggle with, to be honest with you. I'm pretty good on that department. But if I know that I'm really going to knock it out the park, sort of like beforehand, beforehand you have a good hard wank and really pull the head off it.
Right.
It desensitizes the dick.
Brilliant.
So that when you are fucking, you can last a lot longer as well.
Well, you want the round two strategy.
Yeah.
What I'd also say is, she sounds like the kind of girl who you've already tried to talk to. In any relationship where you want to make the sex better, you can just talk about it. If you've got a good relationship, you can sort of be, I'm not saying it as like an iron cast relationship, but you can be like, look, I want to last longer. What can we do?
Slow down a bit, please.
What can we, can we not do it in it? Can we not do it so near a school?
Particular slow down, things to go to when you're like, fuck, I'm going to. What did you do?
Okay, the best advice game. Well, obviously, I'm assuming that he's using a condom. And if you're not, then please do.
Especially,
good
luck. I think he did say that.
Yeah,
no, look,
it's
says
a joy
podcast.
Okay,
let's get on that.
She
helped, though. Yeah.
But Carl's
had a few drinks.
Yeah, I'm smashed. Yeah. No, I'm fucking. I'm literally fucking hammered. Anyways, the way this goes on,
is that like four bottles of wine? Yeah?
The way you make it not seem as short as it may be, switch positions. Boom,
brilliant.
Hit the different positions.
Does that not take it away from her though? Because every time every girl I've been with,
You only lasted 30 seconds. I was like, actually, I didn't. I mean, you might not have had a great time, but
it took us 5 minutes to switch positions.
Exactly. No. But actually,
Women like to be thrown around.
That's one thing I do fucking know.
Right. I mean, how would you do that in a car?
It's in a car, isn't it? I've fucked in a car before, and there's really only two positions, isn't
which
it?
Which car? No, but the question was which car?
Ford car, if you have.
Oh, yes, I had one of those.
It wasn't my Ford car. I was in the passenger seat lying.
Mate, I have never looked at a car as much as that.
She mounted, you know, she rode.
She took
me.
You for a ride.
Yeah, she did, yeah. Definitely did. On the gear stick. No,
fifth gear.
Personally, I've got the other problem a lot of the time, which is I have to absolutely smash the back doors in to come. But one thing, how about it? I think if he's 16 years old, he's probably just not familiar with. Right. The cunt. He's sorry, getting in there.
Why did you just say the vagina?
Why, you dumb fuck?
Why?
The vajayjay. He's in there, and right. The novelty factor is still very high.
Sure.
So he's getting in there, yeah. And he's like,
oh, this is good.
Well, yeah, he's only lasting 30 fucking seconds, mate. It's like countdown.
Or 10 minutes. I mean,
so how about you just eat her out and get yourself used to it?
Right.
Get yourself used to it. Start sucking clit, get your face in there and get used to it. So the novelty will wear off. You'll know what's going on down there.
Yeah, his tone is saying,
he's putting on a pedestal.
Right.
He's worshipping it. Right. You need to just own it.
Right. I think what he's saying there is own the situation. Maybe take a little bit of control and that might give you the longer.
I just feel like use the experience to learn from it. He has such a good position where is he like, this girl wants him and is saying like, oh, you lasted 10 minutes, but he can learn with her. Like, yeah,
yes, exactly.
Like, he's position.
He can level up. He can level up.
Because a lot of lasses with a shit can came after day one.
Exactly.
So the fact that she's sticking around, you need to use the situation.
Yeah, I'm going
to
put it this way.
Anyway, this is a library card. Keep going back. Keep reading.
At the moment, he's a Squirtle. In the end, he'll be a Blastoise.
Yeah. But he has to really take that. Anyway. Hey, he gave me shit for being drunk. He just spun
up. I'm just doing it.
All right.
This has been one of my favorite podcasts.
All right, here we go. Okay, hi guys, love the podcast. You can call me Jeff.
Hello, my name is Jeff.
My name is Jeff. Hi Jeff. I'll get right into it. I've always been overweight and was looking for a bit of advice. I'm 6'4". I'm 18 stone right now.
Wow.
Like Brian.
I was gonna say, is this you?
I am overweight.
Like Brian, I'm always in the gym, so I'm not just a blob on the couch.
I'm not gravy in it.
I'm not looking to become skinny. Like me, but I was wondering if benching weights is an effective way to nullify man boobs. You know, just turn those tits into pecs. Is that something either/any of you have dealt with before? All the best, Jeff.
So we should pass this over.
Yes, so I know.
I'm useless.
So when I hit, I was literally skin and bones till I hit about 12, and then I went. I was always broad and tall, but I just had nothing on us. Great. And then puberty hit, testosterone hit, and me belly hit, and the man boobs hit. Do you know what I mean?
Stella
hit. I was literally like, what the fuck's just happened? Because I went from skinny to fat overnight.
Did that affect your self-confidence?
Oh, it actually did, you know, because I remember thinking, what the fuck, I've got fucking tits, like they're for girls.
You were like, these are great.
I'm looking at the girls in my class at 12 going, I think mine are bigger than hers as well. Yeah, but it's genuinely quite an upsetting feeling for lads out there, because like, I know that women are like going around right now, and you see all the models, your body, your beauty standards, and all that. But men have we all have self-conscious. We get self-conscious ourselves. And you want to look fucking decent, especially when you're like a young lad. So I was pretty like cut up about that. The only way to get rid of them is to either lose the fucking fat.
How'd you do that? Do you have to do weights?
So,
it's high reps, isn't it?
No. So it's not high reps at all. It's all about fat. Literally lose the fat.
Yeah.
Weight training is not going to lose fat at all. I mean, it can in a way if you do high intensity. But the bottom line is diet, cardio is what's going to get rid of your man boobs. That is the only thing. And if you've grown breast tissue, which is from when you're a 12-year-old, 13-year-old, yeah, puberty hits, testosterone hits, and some people have very high testosterone. What happens is your body tries to balance out. So the testosterone goes up and the estrogen goes up with it. And one of the symptoms of that is breast tissue. So you can lose the fat sometimes and still have like big nipples or whatever. And if that happens, you need to have surgery and get rid of the, and there's nothing you can do.
Which is perfectly fine to have surgery at that point.
Someone who did have surgery The Rock.
Yeah.
The Rock had his nipples.
But that's in his DNA.
Well, he's Samoan. He had big nipples. If you look at him in his early days at the WWE, he had really puffy big nipples. And some people say it might have been because he was on the gear. Some people,
how do they do nipples?
So what they do is
someone else's nipples, like nipple transplant.
We need the cosmetic doctor.
They basically we're missing the guest. They open it up and they just pull the tissue out and then sew it shut again. But you're going to have to look into either, if it's fat tissue, you can just lose the fat. Right. Good job. Go on a diet, you're fine. If it's actually nipples, mate, then you have to go and see a doctor.
I actually found high reps are actually quite good for losing weight.
No, well, they probably are for you, but you've got the metabolism of a fucking rabbit, mate.
Right, okay, yeah. Can I just say quickly,
is that obviously I live in a flat and everyone in my flat is actually recently on sort of like a gym grind. Yeah. A lot of them have been doing it for a couple of years now, and there's like two or three people that have really been looking to lose weight. Mm-hmm. And obviously that's the complete opposite to me. I've been looking to gain weight. Mm-hmm. But what I can say is what these people have done, and they've done it successfully, they lost a lot of weight and recently as well, is one diet is like 70-80% of what it is so big. And then the second bit is realistically you have to be doing high intensity cardio almost in intervals as well. Mm-hmm. So you do like sprint really hard, blah blah blah, give yourself 30 seconds rest, blah blah blah, blah, you know, do it like that. And that's the way they've done it. There's probably other ways to
if
do
he's
it.
Always yeah, in the gym and he's 80 in store and the chances are a bit of cardio is going to take care of it, but for regular people listening to this going, I need to lose weight, you have to like actually really push yourself in the gym. There's a lot of lads who I go in the gym with.
Ooh, yeah, hard.
See, I feel like I'm probably good at this too.
Look at them and I go, you'd literally just be doing no harm to yourself if you were sat on the couch at home now, because you'd literally, like, people come to the gym and they fanny on, but they're not really doing a great deal, and it's not their fault, but yeah.
Do you also think that when you're a teenager, and a lot of guys are told, this is the interesting thing with men, they're told you're supposed to control your body. So it must be quite unusual for a teenager when they suddenly get fat or when they suddenly get like whatever it is. And it feels like it's out of your control.
Well, it is.
But that must be quite scary.
It freaked me out when I was 13, because I remember people used to say, because I used to eat a fuck ton when I was like 11, 12.
They were like, oh, you're
people used to joke on, I don't know where it all goes. It must go to his feet, because I was literally, I was quite built similar to you, to be honest. And then overnight,
there were 7 sellers a night. Fuck me.
Spots came, and the fat came, and the body hair came as well.
Did you deal with it straight away, or were you just like...
My mom took us to a doctor because I had quite bad spots, and they put us on tablets called, I think it was oxytetracycline.
That's the word, dries you out.
And it's supposed to get rid of your spots. It helped a little bit. And they also said going on sunbeds would help as well.
But I was like, fuck, really?
I'm not going to go.
I don't know the logic behind it, but
apparently it can really help your skin. I was quite bothered because, like, I've always liked women. And when you're piling the fucking weight on and you're getting spotty, you don't feel great about yourself. Do you know what I mean? But I think that's why I went to the gym, because I was like, I might be fucking looking like shit now, but this is not going to last. Yeah. And then eventually I got myself in good shape, and then I thought, actually, I quite like looking like shit. Let's go back there.
What we're seeing with this next one. Do one more joke of an email.
Oh, okay. Look at the email address.
Wait, what is it?
Whoa. All right.
It's a good one.
Hello, we've got a caller.
Hello, my guys. Okay, all right. So if you have one question for WillNE, what is your question? One question for WillNE.
You're live on Capital.
If they say the word squirt, I'm going to punch someone.
How old are you, Will?
I'm 21.
He's 21. All right, that was a shit question. Let's get a good question.
Come on.
Can you put me back onto Will, please?
Oh, no.
Will doesn't want to speak to you. He wants to know what your question is.
Come on, what are we saying?
Carl's so fucking hammered right now. Hold it, look at me.
Oh, I just can't be arsed, to be honest with
you.
No, literally.
That was Calfreezy. That's how he treats the fans.
Absolutely not, but come on. I gave him a chance to bang out a banging question.
He wasn't your fan, so fuck him.
And he asked what age he was.
Just one of Will's fans.
I can talk to
your fans.
So how often does your number leak?
Well, so basically, when we were at Leeds Fest last year, I was like,
Have you not changed your number since you blew up?
No, so I tweeted my mate's number and be like, oh, call this, pretend it was me, and it like literally broke his phone. So we were like out for a meal, and he did the same to me, and it still rings sometimes.
So you haven't changed your number since then?
It's not that deep, it's only like once every 2 days or something.
That's annoying though, isn't it?
Oh, sorry, you know, I don't have over a million subscribers, so.
Don't worry about it,
I just live in the Halo Tower, so.
Keep working with the right
you
people.
Might you might as well.
Have you got any?
I fully might.
Any Twitter questions?
Oh, he's got a lot of Twitter questions. You should. Should play in that YouTube All Star game. You do really well off that.
He's
mate.
Playing.
No,
he's
he
playing
did. He paid 500 quid to Simon Miniman.
I gave Simon a reach around for that one. So
wow, is that what 500 quid's called?
Why do people? Why are people getting called? Mini Minter stands or something at the moment.
Yeah, because everyone's like, I would like to have sex with Simon Minter when they're 14 years old. So that's what they're like. Oh yeah, that's their way of.
All right, here we go. Twitter. Anyways, enough of that, right? So we've obviously I tweet out saying any questions.
Do you use the Twitter app?
I use the Twitter app because why not? Yeah. Anyways, so the most embarrassing thing you've witnessed. Just witness. Like, witness that someone else, it's not you, is so have a quick thing.
So, Newcastle, I've been out on a Friday night, Tiger. I've seen, you know, it's not like dresses, but you've seen jumpsuits. I've seen someone literally, you know, you go to the smoking area, I've seen someone go to the smoking area, just walk outside, and just, this girl, literally, like, no bra, no underwear, just literally just take off a jumpsuit and just have a piss on the side. Like, literally,
that's disgusting. That's disgusting.
I don't know if it's embarrassing because she was fully up for it. I mean, she wasn't embarrassed, but...
And for pissing
herself. I've watched a girl do that before, and I kind of like the sort of...
It doesn't count when it's on you.
So weird, man. No, it wasn't on me. I hate it when it goes like this.
No, but I like it when a girl is a bit like...
What? Zero inhibitions, drunk.
Filthy.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that took a turn.
I mean, when you say filthy, you don't want to have actual shit on herself.
No,
you,
I don't want to go...
You would not put it past him.
I'm not, I don't mean that. I just mean, in general, I like women who are a bit don't give a fuck about sex crazy.
So you've seen someone's weed on you before?
No, I'm not. That's not happened. It was genuine.
I just
want
to give you the platform to say that.
I'd be the first one to admit it. I've got nothing to be afraid of at this point.
Absolutely not. Mm. No.
Right.
All right. Anyways, next question, and I simply want a yes or no answer. I cannot be fucked for it. Right. All right. The next question is: what do you think of pineapple on a pizza? We'll start with.
Wait.
Start with Laurence.
Yes. Of course.
Yes.
Yeah. It's a no.
Yes.
Come on.
Yes, pizza. Let's pineapple. Go. We'll Let's be different. Go. Come oh, on. Sorry. We'll go against the grain. No,
anyway,
it's wrong, innit?
Why?
No, like no, a no. Pizza.
No, I said it was a yes or no.
I would have.
I'm not going to do this again.
Carl's absolutely fucking rough.
Ooh, all right then. Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, it's a bit of a sour topic for certain people here. But in terms of the match coming up on the 21st, which is for charity and it's for a good cause.
For those that haven't.
We would love to hear your predictions for the game.
Sure. I think the Simon will take it.
I don't
care. I think that the game will definitely be worse off without me and Laurence.
Okay, so once that's been established, what do we think the score is?
The one thing I was a bit gutted about that not doing the commentary, because I just had to turn it about me again.
Sure.
It's your podcast.
Is I actually know all of the lads so much better.
Better now,
than since the first one.
You know who Toby and, his name?
You can tell the difference between them now.
To be fair, we had a monitor that was shockingly bad. But
yeah, it's not like they were right there on the pitch.
No, what I'm actually saying is, I wouldn't actually rinse them less. I would have so much more dirt to work
stuff,
with.
Yeah.
So we will be doing an alternative watch along on the True Geordie YouTube channel. Imagine. So if you want our alternative, I won't. Mini Minter, I'll be on me or straight away or whoever is, whoever it was.
We're not pointing the finger.
He said Mini Minter. It could have been anyone.
Esquire Simon Minter writing to you today.
No. What were we saying predictions?
I think, if I'm completely honest, I think the Sidemen will take it because they do have some quality players.
I'm not going to reveal because obviously
you know stuff.
I know stuff, right? But what makes you think that the Sidemen?
Is there
are
a certain player that you think?
There's no professional.
I think Will's on the same way, and I don't want to ruin it because I don't want there. You know, I want there to be surprises.
There's a surprise coming,
anyways,
guys.
There are certain sets of people.
And if you're planning on going now that you know that there's a surprise,
it's more even than you think it is.
But no. But go ahead. What was your reason?
The F2.
No, the F2 are not involved.
They couldn't afford them.
Couldn't afford them.
I did not say that.
obviously, so Simon's obviously going to play on the Simon side.
Well, I would assume so, yes.
Yeah. And then there's...
Simon's actually a really good player.
Then there's, the brothers, who you would think... Toby and Manny.
Toby and Manny, very good.
And when I say the brothers, I mean the two brothers,
Okay. We found the real... Lauren's exposed. It's all over for him. Anyways.
This has fully gone over my head.
Those two brothers. those two black fellows, yes.
You get it. Will's like, oh yeah, now I get it.
Yeah. I think those two alone can probably win you a game because they'll outscore the opposition.
Yeah, I'll tell you, he's actually quite a good player.
So is it those?
GMX is quite a good player.
Yeah,
he's a steady bloke. He's a steady bloke. If he gets a normal size shorts this year, fucking hell.
GMX is quite a good player. I was surprised.
In many ways.
It's Chris MD.
Chris MD's quality. Chris MD's great, but the problem with Chris is he plays too deep, so he can't be the one who's always scoring the goals.
You need someone alongside.
Chris is
like a Geordie.
Like
a big Geordie.
Yeah, Will's starting on the bench somewhere.
Chris is a Coutinho type character where it's like, if he can come into a game, it's fantastic. But the opposition's always going to outscore. It's like Liverpool playing Real Madrid.
Yes.
He needs.
To be honest, I thought after the Sidemen FC Twitter account got all of those tweets in, if Geordie's not on commentary, we demand
Stop
to see him.
We need I to was play you false the call. Nine. That's what it is.
Never got the call.
Not yet. Anyway,
offended a lot of people.
We need
True Geordie Medio Centro. That's what it is.
A water boy.
Warboy.
Yeah.
Warboy?
I've got the same aggression as Bobby Boucher, so that's actually doable.
Okay.
My
prediction, Sidemen FC. That's
No. I don't want to want to know I want to know results.
All right, okay. Seven four.
Yes.
I'm gonna say 5-4 YouTube All Stars.
I'm gonna say I'm gonna change.
WillNE score.
Yeah.
What? I've got to go for my boy. So 6-5 YouTube All Stars.
Oh, I'm getting wrong again.
For me, YouTube All Stars, I think this year we're going to be looking at 7-4 YouTube All Stars.
Wow. That's pretty deep.
Any other questions?
Yeah, sorry.
We've got a couple of more minutes.
Absolutely.
Let's max out the studio time where we've still got them.
There's no producer here.
We've got to work this fella as long as we can.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
A lot of people actually just about asking about the charity match.
Yeah. I mean, that must be really annoying.
You guys aren't involved.
Yeah. I'm still going to give money to the charity.
All right, so
we owe them for last year, to be fair.
You do.
All right,
if anything, they owe me for all those messages.
Thanks for all the subscribers.
Yeah.
So this person, Els, I just call him Els. What is an embarrassing thing you've done recently? So in terms of recently, we'll say within the last month. Has there anything you guys have done?
I'm trying to think of something embarrassing.
I stub my toe a lot. I've got quite big, wide feet, and when I walk around the house or whatever, and generally in front of people, my little toe, I'll not calculate it, the distance from that to the curb or whatever, and I'll smash it in front of people, and then I'll have to hobble away and be like, you know when you try and like walk it off, but then everyone's looking at you going, see that big fellow over there, he just really hit his foot.
Ideas down his face.
There is something quite funny about watching people fall.
a pretty shite question. I'm going to move on to the next one. Right. We're going to go with...
Because Will can't reveal his insecurities.
All right, if you guys have one guilty pleasure each, what is your guilty pleasure starting with
Will?
Oh
my God, right, guilty pleasure. Shit. Cheesy.
Oh, that is that's a bit dirty, bad.
To be fair, I was once going to tweet out, like, I reckon I could guess other YouTubers... not insecurity, but guilty pleasures.
All right,
like,
what's my guilty pleasure? And I guarantee you,
but Chris
MD
definitely watches, you know, the film Goal every night before he goes to bed.
Oh, that's so
every
true.
Time
that's,
so
that's a banger movie, though, to be fair.
Yeah, exactly.
Goal I remember when I first watched Goal and he was running along
Timehouse
Beach.
Wait, is it Newcastle? Yeah, you must have done that.
That's the beach I go to.
Exactly. it's real, isn't it?
That was my claim to fame for like 20 years.
So what's your guilty pleasure then?
Guilty pleasure.
Because he's not guilty about his thing.
No, that's very hard to make me guilty.
Yeah.
I haven't got a conscience for one thing.
Do you want to
do yours while
I'm trying to think of what my guilty pleasure is. I don't really feel like guilty about anything I do.
I didn't sack you both. Right. Taylor Swift. I actually love Taylor Swift's music.
You do look a bit like it.
Music wise, what's my guilty?
No, I actually really like Taylor Swift music. Like, I could.
The thing about Taylor Swift is she's quite a snooty sort of posh.
John Legend and Ariana Grande singing Beauty and the Beast is actually quite a good guilty pleasure. Yeah,
that's such a Lawrence thing, though, isn't it?
Like, don't do him like that.
Fuck, give me something juicy.
really can't talk about.
Like Iggy Azalea? I mean, no, not into the thing that. Is, our music is so shit, but like...
I like mashups.
Surely there's someone out there is like, I love that, sure.
But I'll just watch a music video just to...
She's not buff though, isn't she? She's not buff.
No, but she isn't, but she's like she's trashy not. Sort of...
She's exactly your type of girl, basically.
She's very.
I don't
curvy.
Mean that in like an insulting sense.
Oh yeah, because like, there's
sense. Would you actually? Would you say you go for like the more of the trashy girl?
No, I definitely. Oh, no, I actually prefer a posh girl.
No, yeah,
ideally, I'd like them posh with curves. That posh because curves. I like something where
that's a rare,
it's a bit of a challenge. A but when I get my hands on them, I devour.
It's one name devour. That we all know. Okay. We all know one name purely because of you. Anyway, let's move on.
Oh, is that the blonde girl that you chat shit about? Okay, cool. What's the next question?
Iskra Laurence.
There you go.
Come on. Anyway. Where's this other question?
Oh,
another one.
Shite.
We'll do one more before.
Last one. This is the
last one.
Last one. Okay. Last one. Let me find a good one.
Like, you've got
and just in case you guys were wondering, like, oh, where's Cal's getting these questions from? You know, at CalFreezy on
If you were religious, what religion would you choose?
Oh, that's a good one.
No, that's a shite one as well.
Underrated YouTubers.
I was just trying to open the bottle.
Oh, to be fair, underrated YouTubers, could you name one?
Usually when people because I used to have like meetings with companies and they'd say if we couldn't invest in you who would you invest with, and I used to say WillNE every time, but now he's like so big it's like I've got to think of someone else really.
Spencer Owen
I'd go Stephen. I honestly personally
he's underrated.
I personally think Stephen does it best in the
Stephen
UK.
Tries
yeah,
Stephen tries.
I genuinely think there's no one producing as
do you know what's weird about Stephen
I wouldn't watch
Did you not see I got a puppy? Did you not say I got a puppy? Do you know what I mean?
To be fair, I got a puppy. You are quite underrated, I think.
I am. I could do honestly. It all. Anyway, but Stephen tries.
Stephen tries is great.
He's fucking class.
Yeah, but the thing was it literally just about to say was the fact that I wouldn't watch every single one of his videos, but like I would say every one in three videos are absolutely
amazing.
He has
someone who's underrated, in my opinion. Vujanic.
I love Vujanic.
I think Vujanic
is a legend.
He uploads so rarely, but when I watch one of his videos.
I watch his latest one, the Foreign Boys.
Yeah, exactly.
That is fucking
unreal. But when I watch his videos, I always watch another three. Mm-hmm. But I was like.
I just watch one at one time.
Yeah, but if he uploaded more, I just think he'd be fucking huge. Like, as much as he's a big personality, he would be massive if he uploaded more, because I think he's so talented. But anyway.
And not to mention, he's a fucking great guy, too.
Oh, he's so nice.
He's such a sound guy.
He's one of the, like, nicest
YouTuber.
Underrated YouTuber now.
There's a guy. Do you know who Nicholas Omelana is?
No.
He makes sketch comedy like Steven. He is unreal. Anyway, really sorry, good. Go on.
No, to be fair, I would still like say Steven is quite underrated in the sense that like, you know, he's not blowing himself. So if for me it would be Steven. But there's no one else that I'm literally just
really?
Like, oh, right
no
now.
One.
Like in underrated, so right now I watch the David Dobrik.
So
that's my favorite vlog series at the minute. Yeah. Joe Rogan, his podcasts are amazing. I'm the True Geordie podcast I watch is amazing. But that's literally just about it that I watch. So
choose to be. Joe Rogan is like
the hero.
He's played by his own rules. No flashy thumbnails, no flashy titles. He hasn't used any of the tricks.
It doesn't matter.
Just good fucking solid content.
Yeah. Like guys, did you watch the Degrassi Tyson just quickly?
I did watch it. And, he does blow your fucking mind, that cunt, doesn't he?
That guy just made it seem like sex to me.
Are we ready to just fuck this off now, lads?
I think we're done.
I think we're done.
Nice one.
I'm smashed enough.
Lads. Yeah.
Thanks very much for coming on.
Been an absolute fucking legend.
Boom. There we go.
Steady on there. Enjoy this shit.
To WillNE.
Which
and
camera?
Subscribe to CalFreezy and Rebel FC.
This one.
Oh, wait.
One.
Sorry, this one. This one.
All right, what, you tell them what you got to say.
Rebel FC, check it out. And also CalFreezy. Yeah, boom. That's me. I'm done.
I just bully children on the internet. Just subscribe to us.
Check it out.
It's good fun. Well,
you can check his Snapchat up here.
Finish this.
Go on. He doesn't want it.
Like the video.
I want you to move that
Thanks
way.
Thanks for watching. See you later.
Bye.